Yeah, you're checking out Opie and Anthony. Greg Giraldo has joined the program.
Greg?
He absolutely...
Been a while.
Yeah. He absolutely killed on the Flavor Flav roast.
Oh, yeah.
You were the best.
Oh, well, thank you.
You were the best. You were good.
Yeah. It helps to be racist.
Yeah, when you get a good theme like that, yeah. Where you can just be racist.
Yeah, when you
and no
like
one's...
Well, it comes from the heart, you know.
Yeah. You really don't... The stuff just writes itself on a daily basis, doesn't it?
Just keep flowing.
Dude, King Lear in a forest fire was just such a beautiful...
Yeah, describing Flavor Flav, of course. Yes.
Attacks on Brigitte Nielsen. It was really vicious, man.
Oh, yeah.
Everything arose.
I think we played some of your stuff. Good. Do we still have that, E-Rock? We could get another play out of that if you find it. Greg Giraldo playing Gotham Comedy Club here in New York City tonight through Sunday. Also, Dan's got an update on his mom.
Yeah, well, when we left, left. Okay, hold on.
Yeah.
I suck. God, I suck.
Nathaniel was at dinner with his mother and his girlfriend, and they have a very strained relationship. And he called his mother a sociopath.
Yeah.
Really?
You made it sound like his mother and girlfriend, like one person, dude. That's really
I would have said slash.
Oh, okay.
Mother slash girlfriend.
Yeah, they got into a very uncomfortable situation.
Well, there's more to it. Than comes from divorced parents.
Mm-hmm.
And he blames his mom on the divorce. He likes daddy much more than mommy.
Mm-hmm. Mother.
Yeah, mother.
Yeah, it's creepy because he calls her mother.
Calling your mom mother, there's a problem.
There's some sort of killing in your face.
You're definitely going to have the knife and the wig and
so
have a girl in
the last job. We left you, Than went to dinner, yes, with his mother and his girlfriend, and they got into it a little bit, and they were talking about the divorce, and you were blaming mother on the divorce,
yes.
And your mother walked out because you called her a sociopath?
I called her a sociopath, and then I said I didn't like her.
Yeah, so she walked out and said, I hope you have money to pay for this dinner. And he was in Nantucket, and they were at a nice restaurant, and, you know, Than doesn't do that well with the show, so he was left with a pretty good bill.
It just showed up. It's $440.
Oh! $40.
Wow.
Damn!
Wouldn't have signed on for that second bottle of wine.
Was that three people?
Yeah.
What drunks?
Yup.
Really, that's what I'm thinking.
And booze.
These are pretty upscale problems, huh? I was dining with mother in Nantucket. When dining with mother in Nantucket, one ought to keep one's card handy.
He is using the proper name for mommy, because it is Nantucket.
Yup.
I'm sure they all call their mothers mother.
Mother.
And you hadn't talked to her since?
No.
And you got an update on this?
Yes, I still haven't. This is all... via my sister, as all healthy discussions should happen between a third party. She says, she reminded me of the most hurtful thing. The thing I hurt her with most was at this dinner, I said, with a smile, apparently, I didn't realize I was smiling through this whole discussion, was, I only pretend to like you so I could stay up here.
Oh.
You said that to her?
Yeah.
Because Nantucket is a nice place to visit.
Yeah.
I only pretend to like you.
Because I knew the break was coming up. You know, we had the vacation. I was like, I could spend X amount of dollars to go to another place, or just there's the psychological cost, the non-monetary cost of having to hang out with mother.
And it probably would have been better, in hindsight, just spending some cash.
Yeah, I should have
which you did
Europe.
Anyway. Yeah. And, $440 now. Yeah. And where does it stand now with you and mother?
Well, she says that she will never speak to me again until I apologize.
And you probably won't be apologizing.
Yeah, that sounds like a freebie for me.
So, yeah. That's what we call a stalemate.
That sounds like a pretty stable relationship that comes down to that.
Yeah.
A lifetime of memories.
Yeah.
Unless you apologize over the check, it's all over.
Do you have any desire to have a relationship with her?
No.
So you could care less that she said that?
Well, I think, like, family functions, we're going to have to figure something out. It'll just be weird.
It'll ruin it for everyone in the family because all they'll be thinking of is like, how uncomfortable is this that the mother and son there aren't talking, looking at each other. I have to talk to the mother, and then I got to talk to the son, and I can't like cross over conversations.
It's like Connie in Godfather 2. Like, Fredo wanted to talk to Michael, but he couldn't, so he had to talk to Connie. So, yes, isn't it weird? Like, your mother, she like let you stay in her place here, right? Like, you were living with her in New York recently.
Yeah.
And she would let you stay at her place. And then, so she was okay to you. You just hate her because of the way she reacted to your father.
I have a feeling he was okay with her because she has a lot of money. And,
but I mean,
and a really nice apartment in New York and a nice place in Nantucket. So he tolerates her.
But how about her with you, I'm saying? Like, because her obligation to you as far as being a young man is over.
Yes.
So she allowed you to stay at her place.
Mm-hmm.
And then she allows you to come up and stay there with her, and she takes you out to dinner.
It's always like a barter, though. It's like, it's a everything's a transaction. So, like, the second I moved in there, the clock was ticking, and, you know, the favors I would have to repay her with started to...
Like what?
Just any... It's just, she hasn't collected yet because I've been kind of a... jerk, it wasn't like, oh yeah, you could stay and there's no problem. It was just she couldn't stop reminding me that I was staying in her place. I mean, it's still cool that she let me stay there without, you know, having to pay rent, but
how long
4 or 5 months, but you know, it wasn't, but it's not like this motherly gesture of goodwill.
That's like amazing. Saving up some points so she could hit you with them later.
So then I will have to do something for her later.
Yeah.
And this apartment, she doesn't even stay there. She
just comes.
She uses it when she comes to New York every once in a while. So any other normal relationship, your mother would just go, I got an apartment in New York. You save some money.
No, stay there.
Yeah, she wasn't being put out at all. Mm-hmm.
At all. That's like what? She comes down a couple times a year.
If that.
So this apartment's just sitting there. Than is struggling in New York. You know, he's making ends meet, but it would be nice if he could live for free and bank that money he would use on rent.
Yeah.
But with his own mother, it has to be, I'll do this for you, but you... What do you have to do for her in return?
I'll destroy you at dinner, and you have to walk out.
Yeah.
I feel like Robin Leach should be hosting this show.
Yeah, I know.
Very different tone.
Lifestyles are the liquored up and dysfunctional.
Yeah. Dave in Massachusetts, the most hurtful thing that Than said is that mother took them to a place where the seared tuna was slightly overcooked.
Yeah.
That's awful.
I'm not earning a lot of relatability points with this.
No, this isn't...
So what would you have to do for her... Just because she allowed you to stay in her place for free for 4 or 5 months?
I just some. Well.
Eat her box?
Jesus.
Oh.
Now it turns.
Not even, got to hear that.
It's not even funny.
Well, it's going to sound very selfish.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But just stuff that I guess people would normally want to do for their parents.
Like what?
Yeah. Like,
would she require a hug, fan?
Yes. She demanded. I'm drawing a blank. Just inconveniencing me.
Like what?
The only example I can come up with is very selfish sounding, like she wanted to be driven to and from her knee surgery.
Holy Jesus. She puts you up for 3 months and wants a ride to her knee surgery.
What a demanding
dude. Wow, you need a therapist. Jimmy called it a while
ago.
With you.
So you
why is that a problem?
I can't get over how the mother could ask for so much. Right. Did she expect you to help her up the steps with bandages on her knee? What a pig.
Why is that a problem? Let's get into this.
Because he broke her knee in the first place.
She slipped going to fetch him something.
Yeah.
So wait.
I knew that. I mean, I knew this example wasn't going to be.
Are you
the
an only child? No, you're not an only child. You have brothers and sisters. You're the youngest
of three.
Wait, you didn't answer the question though. Why is that a problem?
I don't know. Like that was. I felt normal. It's just the.
It was the way she told you, or
were you coddled growing up?
More or less, yeah.
So you're kind of spoiled a little growing up.
A little bit.
Private schools.
Yes.
Oy.
So you kind of...
wow.
I'm wondering if there's any entitlement here on Than's part. I'm not saying that your mother's not...
We've lost every black listener we've had that we've gained over the past few months.
Why?
They don't get this.
Well, the parents are divorced. That'll kind of bring them... Wait a minute. So you were kind of coddled and a little spoiled growing up. So part of it might be your mom and part of it might be like you're a little bit of entitlement.
You're bothered because you...
Dan's not going to blame himself.
No, I'm not saying it's totally his fault. I'm not saying he's wrong about his mom either.
I'm saying it is, but he won't ever blame himself.
Well, especially as your mom's getting older, this is the time to start driving her to doctors and things. You want to keep yourself locked in that will.
Yeah.
You're really playing this game.
Yeah, yeah. Well. She's somebody you really want to lock in.
Well...
Yeah.
She's not the real cash cow in the family.
Oh, father is.
Oh, yeah. Father is.
She's a beneficiary of.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I get it.
So Than kind of sided the right side. So, all right.
Well, what kind of money? What kind of money has he got? Well, not specific numbers.
The look on the face.
Yeah, I'm starting to think.
That's the kind of thing nobody.
I'm starting to think.
How much?
The only reason he likes father is because father has the cash.
No,
father.
See, that's not it. He's nicer.
Yeah.
I'm trying to divorce myself from the concept that I need to be nicer just because she's my mom. Like. I'm not a big fan of her. Like,
you don't think she's a good person.
Yeah, I don't want to hang
just because
out with her.
Where's your dad?
She carried you in her womb, that she's entitled to your love for the rest of her life.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Where's your father live?
Connecticut.
Of course.
So couldn't he help you out with the rent?
Yeah.
Okay, well, they can just ignore her.
Ignore
try therapy. I mean, you know.
Yeah.
Oh, you do good.
I'm doing that, too.
Oh, good. It helps.
Oh, you're right.
That's what this is right here.
Yeah, it was like...
I consider this...
Gordon, I never heard this sound so sweet before.
Yeah, that's good. That really helps.
Well, it's kind of... It's just...
It's the new gym.
Yes.
It's the gym that goes to therapy gym and then tries to let this little knowledge trickle down to all of us. Yeah. Because I started bringing up some stuff from my childhood, and Jimmy had it all figured out.
That was right.
Just from a couple of therapy sessions, he figured out that I was the child of an alcoholic father. So that gives me these. That's why I'm paranoid,
right.
And I have guns, and I always think people are going
to
invade my home, and that's why I have weaponry.
Fix everything. You need to be in control of your whole situation.
Right, right.
You never know when daddy might get drunk and give you a good smack.
That was it, pretty much. It has nothing to do with watching the news and seeing home invasions in my town shoot up 10,000% that I wanted to buy a shotgun.
Well, that's part. Of course it is. But I'm not talking about that. I'm not talking about the obvious. It's like, we you know, hey, look, we all are products. I don't know why I do. Why have I ever laid on the floor with bags under me? I don't know. There's like little psychological reasons. You saw your father behave violently, so you're afraid of violence. Mm-hmm. It's not, you don't have to be a psychologist to see that.
He's bringing it to the show. He says, I have an anger issue. It's like, come on.
Yeah. He's now our therapist.
Right.
Jimmy will sit each down, and Than is now sitting on the couch.
Yes.
Quite literally. Yeah. Just lay back there. And Dr. Jimmy is in.
Look,
I don't want you to go to therapy. Because I think you could give us some really good radio, man. I don't want you fixed.
Don't worry, that won't help.
No?
No.
Well, because she's not going, so I still have to absorb all that.
Do you think? That's kind of a morbid question, but it does happen. Do you think if she passes on that you will have any feelings of guilt and feelings that you didn't resolve things? Because that always happens with people. No matter how angry they are at a family member and they don't talk to them and stuff, the second they drop dead, it's all this regret and I should have done this and blah, blah, blah.
Zero.
Zero. Wow.
So when did you start?
Zero.
When did you start hating mother?
That's a good question.
When did you lose the love for mother? You say because of you blame her on the divorce, but it sounds like maybe before that.
No, it's like I needed perspective on the situation and realized that it's not normal to like have every dinner end in screaming, and you know.
Mm. Yeah. Well, I kind of remember that.
Well, I mean, if you're Italian, it is.
Yeah.
Exactly. Oh, God, I've told that one before. I vividly remember a plate of spaghetti hitting the wall and just running down the wall. And that is a memory I have as a child.
And you think if you save poor Catherine, no more spaghetti hitting the wall.
Is that spaghetti still hitting the wall, Anthony?
We got Jim in Boston. He can relate to Than. What's up, Jim?
What's up, guys?
Hey.
Listen, my mother, same way, call me up. They just bother me and call me all hours of the day. I'm an only child. She would just ask me to do ridiculous things for her.
Like what?
She asked me to take her for surgery one day.
What is the problem with that? If mother needs surgery, I think you should give her a lift. Call an ambulance, bitch.
Huh?
You there?
Yeah, we're listening. Go ahead.
So she asked me to take her for surgery one day. And, you know, it was like 11 o'clock in the morning, and then I had to wait, and then I had to go back and pick her up. I mean, it was just, you know, and then she wanted me to stay with her and take her to the pharmacy and everything. It was just a pain, and, you know, I couldn't do it.
Well, this cancer, you know, getting tumors removed doesn't always happen that easily.
Yeah. Sometimes it takes time.
I sense some sarcasm here. They're making fun of you. Okay. Jim, you're making fun of Than?
No, not at all.
You really believe this?
Not at all. I'm telling you. My mother called me up the other night and started a fight with me over my son's birthday party.
What was the fight about?
Well, it wasn't even a birthday party. We're having a birthday party for him on Sunday. And his birthday was on last Wednesday. And we had, like, a little cake because he's 5 years old. And then he told her we're having cake, and then she hung up on him. And then she called me back on my cell phone and started screaming at me, saying that I should have, you know, I should have told her that she was coming. She lives 30 miles away.
Oh, okay. Didn't invite her?
She won't. Yeah, we didn't. Oh,
didn't invite her for the cake?
If we would have invited her, she wouldn't have come. When it doesn't matter.
Then you should have gotten out of the way and invited her and just saved yourself the aggravation, you dope. What's the matter with you?
I already did. You know what? I've done it in the past, and it doesn't help.
All right, so there's no solution.
Nothing
you can
do for a woman like this.
All right.
All right, thank you, Jim.
Awesome. My father was living way up in the country in Connecticut, and he was he had cancer and he had to go in for chemo, but they didn't know how many treatments it would take, and I had to drive to take him into chemo, which was like a 2.5 hour drive. So on the of course it's kind of sad. On the last one, we're taking him in. They're like, yeah, I don't know. You really probably shouldn't come in for any more treatment. And like a tiny part of me had this enormous relief. Like,
oh, God.
So that'll be it then.
They pretty much said, yeah, this ain't working. And
and you were relieved because
no more driving.
Yeah, no more driving to try to keep my dying dad alive.
Oh, wow. Greg Giraldo, everyone. Hey, we got to take a break. So Greg Giraldo is...
Comedy Club, tonight through Sunday?
Yeah, tonight through Sunday. And just a little taste. He killed on the Flavor Flav roast. Here's Greg Giraldo as we go to break. It's Opie and Anthony.
This is exciting, Flav. It really is. This is an honor. I've never roasted an oily cadaver before. You're like a turd with teeth. Look at yourself. I love the crown. You look like King Lear got trapped in a forest fire. You are one black... You're like a skeleton wrapped in electrical tape. You look like Idi Amin after a 3-year crack binge on the sun.
Oh, Jesus. One for the studio. It's Opie and Anthony. Greg Giraldo in studio today. He's playing, Gotham Comedy Club tonight through Sunday. He's hilarious.
Do we have a phone number for that?
212-367-9000.
It's a beautiful club. It's on, where is it?
23rd Street between 7th and 8th Avenue.
Yeah, Mazzilli moved it. It's a really, really nice room.
Yeah. For everybody in the New York area. We got Seth MacFarlane calling in to say hi. Hey, Seth.
Hey.
Of course, we're talking about Family Guy. How are you, Seth?
I'm doing good. I could use about a barrel of a wake.
Oh, you heard us do the live read for Awake, the energy drink?
Yes, I did.
Oh, why, are you a little tired this morning?
It's, I'm out here in L.A., it's about 5:30 in the morning.
Why is that? It's because it's like 8:30 here.
Yeah, I'm confused.
It's amazing.
It's a cruel joke of nature.
Did you stay up, or did you actually have to wake up for this phoner?
No, I woke up about 3 minutes ago.
And you'll do this phoner. You got a whole bunch of them you got to do, or are you going to do this one and then just go right back to bed?
Yeah. This high energy voice that you're hearing is 100% real.
So you guys just got syndication. Were you syndicated before that, or am I saying you just got it because CW 11?
We just started, the show just went into syndication, I think last week.
Yeah, congratulations. Know what's amazing about that? I got to jump in here. The show got canceled.
It did, yeah.
Got canceled, the fans pretty much brought it back, and now it's a huge hit, and now you're up to the syndication point with
syndication,
the show.
Which, you know, that's just the huge checks.
Yeah.
The huge checks coming.
Yeah, we went from rock bottom up to the peak of where you want to be as a television series, so it's kind of nice.
So do you get all the money, and all the voice people kind of sit there and badmouth you because they don't get any syndication money?
Oh, they're incredibly resentful of me for my money.
Yeah.
Yeah, but Seth does a lot of the voice. voices on the show. So.
Yeah, but other people are in there, too.
But he does the main voices. He could get rid of pretty much everybody.
Pretty much everybody and just do all the voices?
Yeah, the show would still do just fine.
How many episodes before you got syndicated, Seth?
I believe it's the first... it's the first few seasons, so it's just about everything up to where we are now. I think
they have no problem with content or anything. Some of these people,
there's always issues with if a show airs earlier in the day, there are certain things. We air at 9 o'clock at night on Fox. The syndicated episodes air a little earlier in the day. There's some stuff that obviously we can't do.
So they're going to cut it out. I mean.
For the most part, the shows are intact. I mean, the stuff that isn't in there is just stuff that the FCC has sort of
right.
decreed is not.
Oh, the FCC, they know creativity. Come
yeah,
on.
They're,
give it to
they're the best.
They just know.
Guys.
You're not afraid about like some of the. Here it is at night on Fox. You could do some stuff that's pretty politically incorrect, and people kind of get why you're doing it because it's the hour that it's on, and it's an adult cartoon. If you start putting it on in the daytime...
It's not even the daytime. It's 7:30. It's only an hour and a half earlier.
Yeah, well, still. It's the children. That's what I'm talking about, the stupid children. Are you a little nervous that you're going to be on the radar and people are going to say, oh, my God, look at this tasteless blind joke they're making, and...
I think people say that already. This is already that crowd is going to be, they're going to be angry no matter what we do.
I think the trick is, and you guys have done this pretty well, is to get every single group mad at you so they don't know whose call to take or who's marching. Like if someone's protesting in front, they don't know. There's blind people, the deaf people, retarded people,
the handicapped.
Yes.
So they're basically sitting there like with a phone on each ear.
Yeah. Yeah.
Not like your big episode of Gay, Black, Jewish, Asian Women and Why We Hate Them.
Oh my God! You know what? I tell you what, we need a story for this week. So
there you go.
I might just use that.
So Jimmy Norton.
What season are you in right now?
We are finishing up writing season 6.
That's amazing.
So seasons 1 through 5 now are being shown like...
volume 5 is now available in stores.
But I'm saying for syndication, like the whole first 5 seasons now are released for syndication.
That's correct. Yeah.
Did you get Seinfeld money?
It's not quite at that level, but it's...
He'd be mad.
Chicken feed.
Where's my money?
Yeah.
The guy, Family Guy, took it.
I already got $250 million to go into syndication.
Or is it just money with Seinfeld's face on it?
Might as well.
Seinfeld money.
Better Kramer's face.
They pay me in...
get it?
Yeah, that's right.
Excuse me, I apologize. I shamed you into a laugh. I apologize.
Isn't it?
Right. Yeah. Well, move on. I apologize. Man.
You get it. Rib.
Go ahead, man. Sorry.
They pay me in DVDs of the first season of 24.
Oh, that's
wow! There you go.
Travis doesn't mind that kind of pay.
No. I've never seen 24.
In love with the goddamn guy.
I heard it's good, and other people have said it sucks.
You know, it's so funny. That's exactly where I'm at. I've never seen it, and I've heard those two things.
Do you watch like other cartoons, like stuff like The Simpsons, or view that as competition you don't want to be influenced by?
You know, it's funny. I watch The Simpsons periodically. I don't catch it every week. But that's about the only current animation that I watched. There was a show called Home Movies on Adult Swim that I thought was hilarious. But it's gone now. So I don't really. There's not a whole lot of TV that I watch in general.
Don't you hate them being called cartoons? Because I heard him say, animated.
Oh, did I just do that?
It's an animated.
Okay, sorry.
You're funnies. The funny papers, things that move? Yeah.
It's like when you're a comedian, people go, that little sketch you do? You put on a red nose and you dance for the amusement of drunken patrons? Oh, yeah. Sure.
I prefer that you call them moving animated laughing illustration.
Yes, features.
What would you say is the greatest? I mean, you know, you guys are like a legitimate powerhouse sitcom. I mean, even though it is animated, what would you say is the greatest sitcom of all time if you had to pick one, or one that you think you were influenced by?
Probably All in the Family. That's probably the that's certainly at the top of my list.
Yeah, and that's something they couldn't make today.
No, you're right.
They could. I mean, that's
Carol thing. O'Connor's dead.
Well, besides that, but that type of sitcom.
There are things that I think they said on All in the Family that probably would be flat out forbidden by the FCC now. I mean, it's a lot. Yeah.
Oh, Charles in Charge, I think, was probably my favorite.
Yeah, that's brilliant. Yeah. Genius.
They might bring it back now that Bayo's got a little bit of a resurgence.
Some heat.
All right,
getting some heat.
The big argument, Seth, has been Charles in Charge or Joni Loves Chachi. Which should he have had his throat cut for first?
You know, they're both so damn watchable. But I would have to say Charles in Charge because it has Willie Ames, who as we know, is now Bible Man.
Is he really?
Did he finally go that route? Yeah, he was pretty much bottom of the barrel.
Plus, he lived under the stairs, didn't he?
He came up with a character called Bible Man, and he's got episodes and everything.
He's got a show on one of the church channels where it's, he plays a superhero. What the hell am I promoting this for?
Look at you. Is he syndicated? Wow, it's amazing how many people. Yeah, no one ever is doing well and goes, I'm just going to find Jesus.
Yes.
It's always the bottom of the barrel. They've been on the VH1. Shows and just showed how their life fell apart, and then all of a sudden Jesus creeps in.
Yeah, prison seems to be a good time. Conversion.
Yeah, nobody ever gets Jesus while they're committing a rape or a sodomy. It's always after, once they get sentenced.
While they're committing it.
It's like, wow.
You know what, Buttercup? I'm going to have to take a time out for a second.
I'm going
to
unball my fist. I'm not going to hit you, and I'm going to walk out this door a new man. Never.
You guys don't need me for this, do you?
No, we like having you in the background. What do you think of because you got a great, strange, quirky sense of humor and stuff. What do you think about some of the sitcoms coming out this season, like that caveman one?
I knew that was the one you were going to mention.
Yeah.
Anytime they can make a television show out of a commercial, I think that's the best of what America
is. Yeah. I was looking forward to about 5 or 6 seasons of the Where's the Beef Lady back in the 80s. Never panned out.
That's
where every time she just walks in and goes, "Where's the beef?" And everyone laughs.
And Yaphet Kotto runs out nude and shows her. A different celebrity every week just runs out and attacks her. Richard Kiel.
Richard Kiel.
Where's the time to make the donuts guy,
He could have had a show.
Here's a bit of trivia. He was actually one of the guys in the Marathon Man who recognized Laurence Olivier.
Yes.
He was trying to sell him diamonds, and then that other tattletale followed him. I know you, you murderer. Wrecked the whole deal. All right, I'm sorry.
Yeah, but I don't know. It just seems they've just run out of ideas.
Yeah. Yeah, it may be. I mean, I do think part of it is there's just not as much you're allowed to do nowadays. Crazy and loony is the less you can do subversively, the more kind of crazy and loony and out there you get, which is. I don't know. It doesn't always work, but I have not seen the caveman pilot. It may be absolutely ingenious.
I'm sure it's hysterical.
My guess is
it sucks.
Not, but
you know what I hear they're doing?
I could be wrong.
I hear that they're doing interviews, and they're bringing around two of the caveman guys, and they come in character and stay in character the entire interview. They will not break character.
Not a funny thing for the entire interview.
And I swear, if that's true, we are booking them, and I am going to hit them with a club and see if he breaks character.
Yeah, but they replaced the original guys from the
Didn't even have the guys from the commercial.
That bad. I mean, how bad did they have to suck?
where they had to get actors to play the caveman.
You don't seem caveman-y enough.
You kind of lose it after 60 seconds.
Which this is, annoys me so much because I always wanted to do a sitcom about the Affleck duck, and now it's just going to seem like I stole it.
You ripped that idea off. No, nothing. Not even deserving of that.
Do you guys get away with more content, do you think? Because I mean, the Family Guy's a pretty edgy show. Do you guys think you got away with a little bit more content because you're animated?
Yeah, you always, you know, you can always get away with more because it's an animated show.
Yeah, why is that? We're trying to figure that out.
Well, you know, it's one step removed from reality. I mean, Peter and Lois are having a fist fight. I don't think you could really do that with Ray and Deborah on Everybody Loves Raymond.
We were trying to tell everybody that we were actually animated on our show.
So we could get,
so
away,
we could
with
get away with more, but it didn't work. We still get in trouble.
Well, that's an outrageous claim.
It really is.
Yeah.
All right. What is what's the big plug before we get you off the phone?
I guess the big plug would be our hour long season premiere this Sunday night on Fox, which is a TV station.
Yes.
And,
heard of it.
We did this episode that is basically the story of Star Wars from start to finish. We did it with the gracious permission of Lucasfilm. Took us about a year to do.
Wow!
And it's I think it's funny, and I think it's also might be the most spectacular looking hour of primetime TV animation that I think you've seen.
You actually got Lucas's permission, huh?
Yeah.
That's pretty amazing.
About it. They said, you know.
You must have not brought up that Christmas special.
I think they try to keep that under wraps.
Yeah, unfortunately, it's everywhere. I love it.
And you have to promise if you draw George Lucas that you give him a chin. Wow, is he awful from the side?
it was fun to do, and it's also the first hour long episode we've done. So.
Did you get to go out to the Skywalker Ranch?
I'm heading up there. This weekend, actually. It's gonna be fun.
How is that?
I haven't been. I'm going up in a few days.
You're gonna go? God, that would be the coolest goddamn place. I bet.
Yeah. I've heard it's.
Take pictures. Send me some.
No, I've heard it's like Neverland without the sodomy.
So why go? Well,
can't have all the fun.
yes, it's like Neverland without the repressed memories.
Watch him makes the X-Wing fighter disappear. Makes.
Yeah, it's all right. You put it wherever you want. You know.
I'm just adding in.
Well,
yeah,
Seth,
plural.
Congratulations on the success, man. I mean, it's really great. You guys are like a real phenomenon and with the DVDs and the syndication and stuff. And just congratulations.
Well, thank you very much. I appreciate it.
Now you may go back to sleep, sir.
Oh, thank you, gentlemen.
We'll talk to you again, man.
Yeah, right. Seth MacFarlane, everybody.
Take it easy, Seth.
Take care.
Bye.
There he goes.
I didn't realize he was around for that long. Syndication, that's nice dollars.
Wow.
That show is dead in the water.
Yeah.
Canceled, and they brought it back to life, and now it's just beyond huge.
Once you get that syndication.
All right.
Dude, they probably gave him $5,000.
Oh, yeah, easy. Couple, two or three grand.
Perhaps more than that, Jim.
Let's say hi to Mark in Jersey. Mark.
Who's?
Yeah, what's up, man?
Hey.
What's up?
Listen, where's Than at? Is he still around?
Yeah, Than.
Yeah.
He's walking around.
Go over there, Than. Hold on. We're running out of show here.
He's wearing his I Hate Mother shirt.
Yeah. Mark's got something for you, Than. Go ahead.
All right, Than, you better, I would appreciate your mother while she's still around, because if anything happened to her, like happened to mine, she'll be gone pretty quick.
Oh, boy. What happened?
Yeah.
Pancreatic cancer?
What's that?
What happened? Pancreatic cancer?
No, her ex-boyfriend came in my house early in the morning and shot her in the head twice right in front of me.
Jesus.
What were you doing while this happened, sir? You can't say that casually.
That's what woke me up was her screaming, and then I jumped out of bed, and a second later I hear two gunshots.
Oof.
So did he know you were in the house?
Yeah. Me and my sister were.
Why didn't he shoot you?
Because she just broke up with him like the night before.
No, why didn't he shoot you, though?
Yeah.
You know, you're like a witness. Question.
Yeah, I went. No, he turned himself in right away.
Oh, he did. He didn't care. He just wanted.
And how does this relate to Than?
Because if he doesn't appreciate, you know, what if something, God for happened to his mother, and then something like that, wouldn't he feel bad that, you know?
Wouldn't he feel bad? I love that he uses that as like a cautionary example of why you should be nice to your mother. You really ought to be nice to your mother, because you know what? You never know. That's one day her ex-boyfriend's going to come in and shoot her twice in the head.
Extreme example.
Sir, I think I can speak for Than when I say that he would paint a target on her head while she was sleeping.
Than, would you feel bad if your mom was no longer with us?
If she got shot in a violent crime, I mean, that works on a whole bunch of different levels.
Hmm. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Something traumatic like that. Not just, you know, slowly dying of some cancer or some shit like that.
Wow, we almost made it.
Yeah, we almost made it
today. Thank you, sir.
Well, as long as we just don't hang out, I don't have to worry about that, right?
So, yeah. So if she's killed violently, that would bother you.
If anybody was killed violently in front of me, it'd bother me.
All right, but let's say it's a car crash.
As long as I don't have to survey the wreckage.
Just put it out of sight, out of mind kind of thing.
Yeah, I hear you.
Wow, he doesn't like mother. We're going to continue on XM. Greg Giraldo in studio. He's going to be performing at Gotham Comedy Club tonight through Sunday. Phone number 212-367-9000. We got to get out of here. If you're not joining us at XM Satellite Radio, we'll see you tomorrow.
Opie and Anthony virus. Get infected.
It's Opie and Anthony continuing with Greg Giraldo. Will Simpson on instant feedback from his home. I don't know what you're getting at. All in caps, he writes, "Can't you stupid bastards answer your live feedback? Maybe you need to hire someone who can read to read them to you." And then he writes, "The first step for retard rehab is admitting you're retarded."
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah?
Funny.
Yeah.
That guy's a card.
He is a card. And he does have his 12 steps down pretty well.
Maybe we didn't want to read that on the air because it's just stupid. All right, anyway.
Scrum.
Greg Giraldo will be at Gotham tonight through Sunday.
Giraldo always has new material. It bugs me. Every time I see you, you got something topical.
Thanks, Jim.
It's
thanks.
It's really irritating. It's always something good that's about what's been in the news in the last 3 days. I'm like, fuck.
Well, Jim, you know, as an artist. What
jokes can I point out?
As an artist.
as an artist, yes.
As an artist, my work. Anybody says, as an artist, you know, they're about to say something ridiculously unbearable.
Unless it's the end of the sentence and the beginning is, I love to get my cock sucked.
as an artist.
Well, I almost forgot about the shift over.
Yeah, the big changeover.
It happens.
I can't stand when you see an interview with an actor or an actress, and they're talking, and they go, "Well, she taught me so much." Yeah. You know, well, and she's talking about, you know, the character. It's you that's playing it. Shut up.
Yeah.
Say, I go into a bar, I do this, I do that. She's so sensitive and so. Shut the fuck up, you self-important twat.
It was you pretending.
Yeah, you were making believe. You were playing make-believe.
And then as soon as the movie's over, she's on to the next one, and she pretty much is like, fuck that character and fuck her.
Well, and I love this one, too. That character stayed with me for so long. Yeah. I would wake up having nightmares. I actually started living the life of... Did you?
Really? Well, how about like a C or D list actress that asked her about a role? And she's like, "Well, I was drawn to the material. You know, I was drawn to the characters." Oh, yeah? You were not drawn to the money, the fact you haven't worked in 12 years. You chose to play Miss Piggy.
Someone handed you a script.
I was drawn to the character of Benjamin Franklin on this bill.
You were drawn to the fact that he said yes.
Yeah. Yeah, this character really, as I read it, it really spoke to me. And I realized, like, why?
Spoke to me.
My car's been repossessed.
I hate that shit.
Doesn't Melanie Griffith have fucking almost a stroke mouth? I'm thinking of Meg Ryan.
They all do now. Everyone from that era, all these women that were like perky or cute back in the 80s, now have those duck lifts, the collagen thing, the facelifting. Their eyes are crooked because they didn't get them right.
They walk around surprised the whole time.
Yeah, they're surprised and they got the duck mouth.
Yeah.
You know what I saw for the first time I haven't seen in years and just haven't flipped through was on that show Las Vegas? With Lara Flynn Boyle's on there now?
Uh-huh.
Oh, yeah.
Holy shit. Because she's got to weigh 80 pounds top, seriously.
Yep.
And she's got these lips. She's got ridiculous. Puffy, stupid lips. She looks like a pencil with lips. It's the most absurd thing.
How they do that surgery, the collagen injections or whatever the hell it is, and go, yeah, this is what I was looking for.
Yeah.
I wanted this.
Hey, I'm distracted because Kim, I don't know what she's getting at here. Kim in Wisconsin, go ahead. You're on the Opie and Anthony show.
Hey, I'm just wondering if you guys ever had something so good it made your ass water.
Yes, Mexican food.
That's why I'm distracted. Explain, Kim, further.
Have you ever had a meal so good you had to lay a towel down? You're leaking so bad it was so good.
You leak from your ass when you enjoy your food.
Wait, you're not talking about, like, the explosive diarrhea?
No. It's so good, it just...
Yeah, she should ask, tell the story in Somalia and see what does this tell us about a culture.
Wait, or she tell this to a doctor, maybe.
Ebola virus. You ever have a monkey fuck you in the mouth so well that your asshole leaks and your eyes do?
Kim, what are you talking about? What was the food you ate that was so good that there was water? It makes your ass water?
It makes your ass water. I've had my husband makes jerky that is so good that... Squish, squish, squish.
I hate you.
Yeah, this might be the grossest woman on the planet.
Squish, squish.
But don't you guys want to know more? Like, no. The water just starts dripping out, pouring out, leaking out, seeping out.
My husband makes jerky. That's so good.
Anyone who says my husband makes jerky, nothing bright is coming out of it.
Jerky or
that
turkey?
Must be good jerky.
Jerky. Okay, so what kind of water? Is it seeping, leaking, what?
I don't know. It all depends on how actually good the meal is.
Is this your bit?
Yeah.
Are you trying to start a bit on our show? Like, you're not explaining yourself.
Never.
You have to lay a towel down, you get naked, and what? It soaks up the water coming out of your ass because your husband makes good jerky?
He makes anything good.
Really?
Oh, my God.
I don't get her.
We really don't get you. Is this a Baba Booey waiting to happen? What are we getting out of this?
Oh, never. It's just a phrase that my husband and I have always said when we've had a really good meal that was so good it made our ass water.
I know it's just an expression, like saying, my teeth are floating. But it's devoid of anything interesting. It's just awful.
Are you a cheesehead?
This is a horrible call.
Exactly.
Oh, no.
I'm actually on my way to Colorado right now. We've moved from Wisconsin to Colorado.
Colorado.
Oh, yeah.
Why?
Go there.
Why'd you bother? Like, I can understand moving from Wisconsin to New York or L.A., Miami, something like that. Why are you moving from one dull place to another?
To make good jerky. Good ass-watering jerky.
Actually, no, they have ass-watering food there.
See, here she goes.
Wow, all right.
Here's what bugs me about
that's
her.
A hot share.
She said ass-watering. Think we'd go, like it's not catching on, the ass.
No. Stop trying to make a catchphrase or
it's
something.
Not catchy.
You suck.
Well, you take care, guys. Behave.
Oh, behave. Oh, you too.
Oh, we'll try. Yeah,
you can't behave. Be careful.
That's funny, Jim.
Ass watering in Colorado. I hope it freezes. I hope your asshole freezes to an anthrax blanket. Stupid.
Hey, we're doing the Miss Pal Talk contest tomorrow. Let's remind the ladies out there.
Girls, attention.
I feel like I've seen a lot more women on Pal Talk the last few days. Are they warming up for the contest? Like, is this chick real with her cleavage?
Duh. That's what they tell me whenever I go, is that chick real or is that like a tape or something? Duh. Duh.
Is Celia for real or is that like a tape?
Celia.
Showing a lot of cleavage. Is she getting ready for the contest tomorrow?
I don't know. I don't even have her up. I'm looking at the lovely Nora. I'm looking at Debris. I'm looking at Lil. I'm looking at Vicky.
Who's the one on top with the fat tits?
Celia.
Vicky.
Oh, Vicky has giant breasts.
Boy, does she. So tomorrow we got $500 for the winner of the Miss Pal Talk contest. Anything goes.
Vicky looks like me with a wig. No offense, Vicky. But I'm seeing myself in you.
Oh, my God.
Oh, what's wrong with you? Look at her. She's
Jim Norton
cute.
With a wig?
She looks like me.
Vicky, could you pull your hair back really tight?
No, just don't smile or anything. Just look straight ahead.
And pull your hair back.
I don't know why I'm seeing me and Vicky.
I just want to see her pull her hair back.
I think Vicky's
pull
cute.
It back. Let's see.
What's wrong with Vicky, Jimmy?
I didn't say anything wrong with her. I like me.
Wow, she does look like she could be your sister a little bit.
Now, Vicky, get now cry and try to talk a hooker out of that extra 20 bucks.
That's right. Now pay a Russian to do a chili dog on your chest and then hate yourself. And try to hug your girlfriend and hope that the smell isn't there. LOL.
Hello.
LOL.
Well, the ladies are warming up.
Who's voting on this, by the way?
Yeah, who is voting? We are.
We're the judges.
All right. And anything goes, and it's $500. I try to get the prize money up, but some dumb lawyer thing. Of course it's another dumb lawyer
you
thing.
You can't change the contest once it starts.
Can't change the contest rules.
What is it? The fucking prime directive?
I don't know.
We can change whatever we want.
You know that I asked for a pair of Foo Fighter tickets? They're playing tonight here in New York City. And because of Elliot Spitzer, they can't give me a pair.
Wait a minute. Why can't they?
You know, he started that whole plugola crap.
Yeah, but that's different.
But now everything has to be documented. Everything. And there's these official forms that are really, really scary. I mean, Tracy the PD has to sign them.
Elliot Spitzer's a cunt.
Language.
He is.
Yeah. Dude, because.
Fucking guy, man.
Because now you can only give out a certain amount of tickets to staff, or then it's considered plugola. It's this whole thing.
You know why? They took something that was a problem, and then they go into areas where it wasn't a problem to try to fix it. Like the payola thing and plugola. There was record companies coming in and giving massive amounts of cocaine and money to DJs to play records. Okay, understand. That could be an issue. They fixed that. And then just, hey, could I have a couple of tickets to go to a show becomes a problem?
It becomes a huge issue.
But is it if you...
So they've already given out the amount of tickets they're allowed to the staff, so they can't give any more to the staff of K-Rock.
That sounds like bullshit.
Isn't that amazing?
What about the cocaine part? Is that
yeah, can we still get coke? And
right.
That explains Mandy.
Wait, you can't even get free CDs? What's that about, E-Rock?
Most of the time, you can't get free CDs because the record company only issues you a certain amount, and that amount has to be given away on the air. You can't give it to staff, or it's considered plugola.
Yeah, and it all has to be documented. Every CD you give away, you got to explain how you gave it away, to who.
You have to have an ID.
Their name, their all their info.
So you're telling me that my friend's restaurant, right, like my buddy got to play, and he's giving me some money, goes, throw out some mentions, and I'm doing it, like there's a problem with that?
No, that's fine.
That's fine, yeah.
McDonald's?
Yeah. Yeah. My friend, his name is Ted King. piece of McDonald's.
By the way, Bill Kay from Philly writes, hey, Opie, Dan Gross in Philly is saying that Kid Chris is going to replace you guys in the morning when your contract is up.
Who's Dan Gross?
He writes the gossip column down there in Philly.
Here it is. The Pal Talk prize cannot go up because of bonding and registration laws in certain states. Mm. What the fuck? That's more lawyer talk for let's just knock all the fun out of everything.
Why are they complicating radio now? They already complicated everything else in this stupid world. Now prizes. It's radio?
Used to be able to give away prizes for blowjobs under the console. What the fuck happened?
If it goes over $600, the prize, we have to exclude New York and Florida. According to Will. Why?
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 Is that because of Elliot Spitzer?
I don't get it.
So where's that rule?
And why Florida? How fucking... I can see New York. It's kind of the center of the world.
Yeah.
But Florida stinks.
So, and who's got more than 600 bucks in Florida?
Exactly. It's fucking flat shithole.
Yeah.
Just a long, flat shithole.
So...
Is that a mountain? No, it's a speed bump. It's a fucking cunty state. It's a cunty boot state. No one likes Florida. Bunch of fucking old people and faggoty trees.
So we'll let you...
Faggoty trees.
Doesn't like trees. He doesn't like the palm tree.
They're awful. They're the fucking robe wearers of fucking trees.
They don't like it because there's no real shade involved. It's those awful. Dumb things. let's see. Well, yeah, so I guess the rumor down in Philly is that Kid Chris is replacing us. Yeah, they don't know what to do with us. Regular radio doesn't know what to do with us, and satellite radio really doesn't know what
Where
to do
with us. Where did that rumor come from?
It's in the paper today, supposedly. Right, Kid Chris in the search.
I'm trying to find it.
Just write Kid Chris, and you'll find it. Dan Gross, Kid Chris.
Mm-hmm.
That's all you have to do.
Mm-hmm.
I wouldn't be surprised, I guess.
Why? They love us. What happened?
They do, but XM controls us for an extra 6 months, and our contract's,
I'm out of here. I'll fucking leave in a second.
You guys need lawyers sitting in here with you.
Constantly. We are constantly at battle with legal.
So why don't we get so, well, whatever.
I heard Bridget Nielsen's going to be taking over.
Look out. What is that in? What publication is that in?
I don't know. We can't find it.
Is it a blog?
Can we call the guy and just see where his facts are from? Mm-hmm. We'll give him a jingle, as we like to say.
No, but we can't find what this guy's talking about, so he's probably just starting some shit.
Yeah, because I was reading on the...
Look, if they don't want us in Philly, Kid Chris would be a great replacement. No problem.
I don't think he would be.
Why? Who gives a shit?
I don't think he would be at all. Kid Chris hates mornings.
I'm not going to sit here and worry about this crap anymore.
Me neither. Bad
morning. Oh, here it is. Okay. Go down.
It's right here.
Yeah, I know, but go down so I can read it. 94 WISP's Kid Chris yesterday told listeners they expect this show to go back to the format, all-talk format.
Former
all-talk format after the station reestablished itself with its new rock format, as it's been doing since last week. Last week, Chris was the station's only host who was not fired, blah, blah, blah. There's also a rumor out there that Chris may move to the morning slot when Opie and Anthony's contract with YSP is up next spring. We asked Chris about the rumor, and he indicated there's no merit to it, but said that if he and sidekick Thomas move to the morning slot, there will be a bloodbath. His war, of course, would be directed at Preston and Steve.
Well, of
course. It could get interesting. There you go. So I guess it is happening.
Literal bloodbath, like shooting and killing?
Everything Dan Gross has said so far has come true. So,
cause oh, really?
He's got some deep inside source at YSP. So maybe they're floating that out there to get some interest. Ah, whatever. Do whatever the fuck you want.
Yep.
What do you want from us?
All right.
You guys got to maybe give up all this big fancy syndication stuff. Just get yourself a nice Topeka.
That's you know it, I mean? Right?
Kick back. You don't have to worry
nice
about anything.
Small town radio.
Yeah, you can do a nice everybody. Remote from the Otis Ford.
Yeah. So we're worried.
Nightmare.
A couple going off in a few directions here. So Miss Powell talk tomorrow. We want to give you ladies more than $500, but as you've heard, it's too complicated to up the prize money.
Can't do something as illegal as that.
Which is so stupid.
Well,
and we were also talking about Greg Giraldo, how he's topical with his humor.
Hilarious. Until that fucking ass leaky bitch called in.
Yeah, she fucked up the whole flow, right?
Something so good.
Her ass is watering?
Yeah, watering.
You ever eat something so good that your ass waters?
No.
Have you ever heard that expression in your life?
But I'm intrigued now that I have. It's awful.
Can you imagine how hot she would have to be for you to even be able to pull off even a fucking semi?
Oh, I know, right?
Something like that.
She says something like that.
This is good. This is going to make my ass leak. Holy shit.
All you'd be thinking of is your crack smelling like hot dog water.
She'd have to be so hot that you'd be willing to lick that liquid coming out of her ass.
What is bonding a contest, by the way?
I don't know.
I've been doing radio since I was 18. I've never heard bonding of a contest.
It's all about so you can't fix it. And I get that they have to do that because people would be dishonest and shitty and give money to people who would give them a kickback. We, you know, fine, but don't be such fucking faggots.
Like we care.
That's my whole legal explanation.
We're just trying to take care of our hot listeners tomorrow.
Don't be such faggots.
Yeah, Your Honor. If it please the court.
Yes. Ladies and gentlemen, the jury, my client's behaving like a faggot.
Complete faggot, please. Res ipsa loquitur ipsum de factorum.
Oh, that's right. Giraldo was going to be a lawyer. I fucking forgot.
I went to law school. I remember reading about hot chicks being only allowed to get paid $500.
Sure.
Now, when did you realize you didn't want to be a lawyer?
The minute I took the fucking law school test, you know, 1990. I graduated in 1990, and I knew right away that this wasn't going to happen, but then I was, like, locked in. What was I going to do?
Right.
That's a lot of time to put in. And
that was a lot of time. And then, you know, I ended up quitting. I quit, and I started doing stand-up, and I was living in this shitty welfare hotel on 32nd Street that my friend was renovating. I was living there for, like, 8 months. And then I got a deal to do a sitcom based on me being a lawyer. So, like, I took that deal money and paid back all those. It was, like, this whole full circle bullshit, you know, where, like, the only reason to go to law school in the first place is to get the paper so you can become a lawyer. You don't learn how to be a lawyer. So, and then, you know, I also started handling a lot of murder cases.
And losing.
Where'd you go to law school?
Harvard. Do you know who I actually represent?
Wait. You can't just casually say that.
I knew the answer, but I wasn't 100% sure.
Harvard Law School?
Yeah.
Giraldo's a smart fuck.
Well, you certainly can't tell now, but at the time...
Harvard Law?
Yeah, it was weird.
And
you know the only legal case? I took all that Harvard learning, and you know what I used? was fucking Jeff Ross, the comedian, got busted because he was doing some college gig way out in Long Island, and it was with Red Johnny and the Round Guy, and some kid in the audience was waving this, like, plastic fake gun around. And I guess it was a very realistic-looking fake gun, so Jeff Ross, like, grabbed it from him, and they started fucking around with the gun, and they end up getting tackled by security and taken in. And, you know, it was supposed to be a clear, cut-and-dry menace, whatever, it was just going to be just going. And I'd never done anything in a courtroom ever, but I knew a guy who was a DA in Long Island. I told Jeff, I'll go out with you. What's the worst that could happen?
Oh, no.
We go out there, they have a picture of the gun, and the thing looks like a gun, so they put it into, like, the fucking weapons charge category. And so I'm like,
this is getting a little too heavy.
Yeah. They call me to the front, I'm like, I have no idea. I thought we were just going to say guilty. And I go, well, you can't plead guilty, sir. That's a 2-year charge.
Oh, my God. Jesus. You could have put him in jail, like, right there.
Jeff Ross is knowing Jeff like I know now, I would have fucking put him away for sure.
Oh.
But at the time,
because he was waving around now.
Because on the picture, when they show the person that I knew was like a fucking 2-year DA, and they were allowed to dismiss these things. They're like, just come down, it'll be no big deal. You don't even need a lawyer. But I said, well, I'll take him down.
Just in case.
So we went down there, and then the judge just called us over, and that person was not authorized to let it go, so it got bumped up to like the gun charge division or whatever. So we had to plead, you know, I have no idea what I'm doing here.
Plead, I have no idea.
plead retarded.
I had to plead. I said, Your Honor, I was just telling dick jokes on a milk crate last night. I'm really not the guy to be settling this legal issue. And we had to go back out. And then Jeff even wanted to plead guilty just to get it over with because they told him it probably be probation.
That's a great idea.
But so we ended up, I think, having to get a real lawyer and come back like about a month later. And
obviously.
It wasn't even his fake gun, right?
No, it was, but for whatever. Oh, and his co-defendant had a record. That was the other problem.
Oh, great.
Like, the other kid that he was fucking around with, the kid that had, you know, had gone to jail for something.
But they know Jeff was a comedian, and they knew the context of what happened.
Yeah, they knew it. But, I mean, he did. You know, he ended up not doing any kind of hard time, but just, you know, they couldn't, for whatever reason, when you have a gun that looks like a gun and it's in the file, that, you know, the kid 2 years out of law, 2 months out of law school can't just clear it. You know, they got to go through some superior or something.
How? That is
amazing. Yeah, I handled that. And I handled the Vince Champ rape case. I don't know if you remember.
What is that?
It's some other comic.
Oh, it's just.
What is that about, Jimmy?
Serial rapist.
Huh?
A serial rapist.
Yeah, he was a comedian. This guy was a comic, and he was traveling around, and he was, like, raping. You know, you're like, oh, this guy's out there raping all the college kids. Like, well, that's what we all do, you know? And they're like, no, I mean physically raping them. He's actually raping them.
He was a comic, and after his show, he was actually a rapist?
Vince Chan.
From town to town?
Yeah, he was traveling around from town to town. He's still in jail, I think. I think he got, like, 25 years.
He got a long time. And
you guys knew him pretty well?
I never met Vince Champ. But it was funny, when it was all happened, they kept showing this Evening at the Improv clip.
Well, them peanuts. How am I going to stay full with them peanuts?
And I want to slow this down a little bit. So a guy who's making people laugh from town to town after the show is a predator.
Yeah.
Raping women. Well, yeah. And he got caught.
Hopefully one of our guys is getting something on Vince Champ. Because, I mean, I don't know.
A comic's pretty good cover for a rapist. You're all over the place.
You travel around, you have reason to be someplace. You're probably coming close to raping people anyway. So
I think what he would say is, could you pray for me at the end of it? He would ask him to pray for him. This is what I heard. And it somehow got connected on the internet. Like, somebody quoted that and said, I think I was raped by this same guy. Because he asked me to pray for, and I don't remember exactly how the description of the car, but then they connected him through that, and his college schedules would kill him because they knew exactly where he was. And what a coincidence.
When someone's got to call Roger Paul for your some national booker to go through your book, wait a minute.
I think we got a rapist.
He did a lot of colleges, though. I mean, he obviously...
Yeah, well...
That's what bummed me out the most.
And like, you did his case for real?
I'm kidding. That would have been a hell of a...
a hell of a step up.
Serial murderer.
I don't know. If you're helping comics here and there, who knows?
No, yeah.
Was he black, someone's asking?
Hopefully.
Yes, he was.
He was a black guy?
I believe so, yeah.
I don't know why they're asking, but came in.
Yeah, he did. I mean, still in jail. 25 years. It was like multiple counts.
Oh, he was a bad boy.
Wow. Yeah,
he was naughty.
He was naughty for sure.
He really was a fresh one. Vince was fresh.
He was a ne'er-do-well if ever there was one.
What happened?
I don't know how. When did that happen, Greg? That's like 8 years ago, right?
About, at least 8 years
He'll
ago.
He'll probably be out soon, I mean.
Ugh.
Yeah. Can't find anything on him?
He sounds surprised that he was doing colleges.
How about
that's like, why wouldn't you? You're a serial rapist. Like, going to do the old age homes, you know?
Hey, is someone saying Ronnie knew the rapist?
Oh, sure he did. Sure he did.
Oh, yeah? Can we get Ronnie on the phone?
Hey, Ronnie.
We haven't had him on the air in a while. Wait. Could see if he's up yet.
Vince Champ rape.
Vince Champ rape?
Not comic.
Vince Champ in quotes. I'll slap your face. Vince Champ in quotes and then rape.
Mm. All right, let's try that out.
Young fucking stupid hawk doesn't know how to Google. There's nothing on him.
Oof. You just had it, I thought.
A lot of these people don't show up.
Don't scream at me.
The just make like you're Googling mayonnaise, but just put in Vince Champ.
Vince Champ, the comic / serial rapist.
Yeah.
Comic / serial rapist.
Great bio. Just,
you gotta have a hook. You gotta have a hook.
Yeah.
Inside the rapist studio.
Wow, that's crazy. All right, we're trying to find more info, obviously.
That's a good story.
And he wasn't even like, it wasn't even just like a sexual predator, like a just a scumbag that was like, you know, date rape. I mean, it's bad enough. He was like a, like hide in the bushes, jump like, out. Into,
just random people kind of
hiding under cars
and
stuff.
Yeah, there was one case, I think he went into a music rehearsal room and hid behind a piano for like an hour.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, it was the real deal.
And he was a comic on top of that.
But he was hilarious, though.
he was really good.
Let's say hi to Jeff in Illinois. Jeff.
Hey, Greg Giraldo. How you doing this morning?
Good. How you doing?
All right, man. I just wanted to give you props. I watched that Comedy Central Flavor Flavor roast the other night. And I'd always heard it on. I'd always heard it on the radio, but when I saw it, and I saw the look that Carrot Top was giving you when you started busting his chops.
Yeah,
it looked like he wanted to come across the stage and choke the shit out of you.
Yeah, he was shocking. Was he was like shockingly upset. Did you see?
Tell he was upset.
You know, like, man, it's bad enough when any normal civilian gets like blown away at the tone of a roast, but when a comedian is sitting there, like, you didn't think this shit was gonna come up?
Yeah.
Why do you make me feel bad about doing my own job?
And it is like Carrot Top is, it's your Carrot Top. It's like, why wouldn't you go goofed on it a
room? Of course.
You have to.
I even told, because he's a very nice guy, I even told him before. I said, you know, some of these things are going to get, I said, I got a lot of stuff on you. You know, you're going to hear a lot about yourself, I'm sure.
How'd you know he objected?
Because he looked like, literally.
You could tell on the show.
If it wasn't for the surgery that had sealed his tear ducts shut, he would have started crying. Like, he literally, like, he got very upset.
Well, let's say hi to John Jersey. He's saying the same thing. John, go ahead.
Dude, I watched you last night. I've got it on my iPhone even. But when he starts his set, man, it was like he was all pissed off. Like you could tell, he was derailed by it until he went to his trunk.
Yeah. Well, you know, the other thing he kept saying, because he was, like, sort of right next to me, and at one point, like, what are these guys, you know, making fun of me? They're all these fat, bald guys. Why are they making fun of me for being in shape and looking good? I thought, are you a child?
Wow.
Are you a professional comedian? Are you a child?
Exactly.
You're right. You're more muscular than some of us.
Yeah, but he has all sorts of other things going on. Doesn't he have, like, permanent mascara on and stuff
he's
like
got
that?
All kinds of...
Your name is Carrot Top. You're fucking
crazy. It's a miracle he got away as easy as he did, I thought.
Yeah. Go ahead, John.
I was going to say, Greg, I know you can throw me down, but you're starting to look like a fat, stuttering John Melendez a little bit on that special.
That's rough.
That does hurt on a number of levels, but I agree with you.
Look at that picture of Carrot Top that E-Rock just popped up.
I think he finally had it with people making fun of him.
That guy's ridiculous.
That's what is going on with this guy. Look at him. He's fucking ripped.
Yeah, he's totally jacked up.
He wasn't like that when he first started out in the business,
that's
right?
Also roids and shit. That's not just normal weight.
That's
he's done bad. He's done
it has to be roids. You can't get like that.
He has that V.
Yeah.
Goes down to the cock.
Yeah, the old cock muscle.
Carrot Top. Dennis from the Bunny Ranch said Carrot Top goes, he fucks a lot of broads in the ranch. He's a pig, man.
Yeah, that's what they say.
I love that.
We're going to have him on soon, I think.
I hope
have
so.
To talk
to
him. Hopefully he'll talk about that stuff.
The thing is, when you're Carrot Top and you're upset, you know, like you storm out of a gig and you're pissed off and that's it. But I saw him the next morning in the hotel waiting for his car and he's all angry. He's desperate to get out of town, but he's got three fucking giant steamer trunks.
Full of his props.
You can't just bolt out. You're like, loading up.
I got to load in and out here. Yeah. Here's what you had to say about Carrot Top.
God, you are a big, ghoulish
top. Jesus. What happened to your face? You look retarded. How did you do that? How did you find a plastic surgeon who could add a chromosome?
That is really...
That's great. I think what hurt him...
He wasn't happy.
It wasn't the lines. It was the immediate laugh of recognition from 1,000 people. Like,
Yep.
Yeah, they always do seem surprised sometimes at the crowd. Because I think they just lose their mind. Especially, like, because he does Vegas all the time. So he's in the same venue night after night just being a giant star. And the fact that anyone would turn on him even a little, he did look like he was going to cry.
Yeah, yeah. If that would have bombed, he'd have been all happy.
Yeah, right, fine.
Like, look, I look great. He threw it out, and no one bit because they all think I look great.
I think
but
also,
they're all
like,
laughing.
Anybody that starts lifting weights a lot, like, if something happens in your head where you really... forget that doesn't necessarily, nobody gives a shit. That it doesn't, you know, in his mind, it's like, but I'm jacked up. Like, exactly.
Yeah, he's gone way past the point of just,
nobody gives a shit.
I want to be healthy.
Yeah, you might want to lose a little double chin.
That's to the point of, you have some kind of inner turmoil that is coming out in your muscles.
When you're trying to get a shredded taint muscle, you push it.
Well, you know what it is when you start.
Yeah, lifting a little weights just to kind of feel good about yourself is one thing, but you're right. When
he's a really cool guy. That thing's
when you're working on that obscure, like, side muscle, then there's issues there.
You know what it is? When you make fun of him, you upset the apple cart.
Yeah, you don't want to upset the apple cart.
Easy on the language,
all right,
Jim.
Listen, we got a break. Greg Giraldo, Gotham Comedy Club, tonight through Sunday. You sticking around?
If you'll have me, sure, man.
Of course.
Sure.
All right.
I'll stick around, get coffee, whatever you guys need.
Someone get Greg coffee.
Want me to dust up? No, I mean, I'll get it for you is what I meant.
Oh, no, don't be
No, for you, Jim, just for you.
Giraldo, we don't have to tell you, he's really, really funny.
Greg is a really
funny love his stand-up. 212-367-9000 for the Gotham Comedy Club, okay? It's Opie and Anthony.
Oh, God.
Oh, boy.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, boy.
Hey, oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Jesus.
Uh-oh, uh-oh. What?
I didn't see that one coming.
Opie and Anthony.
All right, we got an Oscar De La Hoya update. Has Greg Giraldo seen the pictures yet of Oscar De La Hoya?
Sexy pictures?
No, I haven't seen them. I'm reading about them.
Yeah, the Daily News gossip column here in New York suggesting that these are real photos. Wow. Oscar's saying they're not real photos, and now he wants to sue.
Of course.
You be the judge. It's
look real.
X17online.com. Look at these, Greg, if you just... This is... allegedly Oscar De La Hoya.
Nice.
Those are great.
How amazing is that? He's in a girly outfit, and in some pictures he's wearing a wig.
Yeah.
Making him a cute brunette.
Yeah, I can only see it from the side angle, but it was disturbingly hot a little bit from the side.
And then the other one, he takes the wig off, but he's still in the girly outfit with high heel shoes on, and he's got his boxing gloves on.
My favorite, the one on the tub, where he's got his one leg up on the tub, and his ball bag
is
Turkish taffying out the side.
Yeah, we couldn't say this on the first half of the show, but that's what we were getting at. His ball bag, look, is doing a little peekaboo here. Look,
here's a zoom in.
Look at this. It's like a bat wing. Look at this thing. His shaved ball bag is falling out the side of his panties.
Funny, you see fucking J. Edgar Hoover and David Ferry running around in the background.
Who's he fighting next?
I don't know. I think he's retired. Isn't he retired?
Desiree Brown or...
Well,
hold on. It's Greg had a great setup, and I had nothing funny to say, so I just gave a real answer.
but it was a tricky one.
To a funny
he's
thing.
Retired.
I stopped it with a fact. Well, no, Greg. All kidding aside.
It was a challenge, though, Jim, to come up with a good one.
But any woman. Like, any woman alive. Minnie Pearl. I could have said that. But what I said is, well, you know, Greg, I think he retired.
You're retired. There won't be any fighting.
He was quite a fighter.
Yeah, back to you.
Well, really known for his left cross.
Well, TMZ is reporting this. De La Hoya fix is in on kinky pics. Photogenic boxing champ Oscar De La Hoya says that a slew of photos making the internet rounds purporting to show him in panties, fishnets, and heels are fake. And he's hired legal heavyweight Burt Fields to give the snaps the old roundhouse.
Oh, boy.
Get it? Still, ooh. Report Russia Molloy, the exotic dancer who says she took the pictures, insists they're real and that they were taken at the Ritz-Carlton Hotel in Philly in May. And the quote is, now that she's being called a liar, she's ready to sell her story, says Gotham Mag columnist R. Curry Hay.
What a fucking cunt.
But Fields swings back saying, as many have, that the photos are a really bad Photoshop job and demanded in a letter posted at usmagazine.com that they be taken off the net a little late.
How could it be a really bad Photoshop job?
It looks like a really good Photoshop job.
If nobody can tell the difference, that's a good Photoshop job.
I got a text from my ex-girlfriend about something totally unrelated.
Right.
About a guy she used to date before she knew me. And I was talking about something, but I was talking about a guy who cross-dresses. And this is what she sent me back. I fucked him in the ass with a strap on. Where are the pictures?
Wow.
I didn't ask for the guy's name.
No. But, that's something.
Very yeah,
rich
it's
boss.
Funny. It's the same perverted.
She's the date rich boss.
Yeah. Hey, we got the great Ronnie B. on the line here. Hey, Ronnie.
Hey, what's happening, guys?
Hey, Ron.
How are you, bud? Bennington.
What do you say, boys?
Well, we started talking about Vince Champ, and someone said you might know this guy.
I know him very well. I know him, of course, years ago. And it was a very, very weird story because he was a guy that like everybody liked. He was the last guy anybody thought would have been involved in something like this.
Yeah, if you weren't listening earlier, Vince, a stand-up comic, touring a lot of colleges, and after his set, pretty much was a predator and possible. Well, I guess he went to jail for it, so he was caught raping women.
Yeah,
he did go to jail for it. And here's the thing: if we were making a movie about Vince, Black Girl would be playing the part of Vince Champ. You know what I mean?
Oh, really?
Well, yeah,
Vince was incompetent.
Guy who comfortably moved in and out of white society. Believe it, everybody liked him. He was everybody's best friend. Nobody could say enough good things about him.
I would say everyone liked him there, Ronnie.
Well, and probably a couple of girls in some of his towns that he visited.
He was so likable that even these girls to this day can barely bring themselves to say something bad.
I'm sure his percentage is way up there, but yeah. I would say everybody.
He was one of the sweetest rapists.
In all honesty, it's true, because when this happened, everybody who knew him immediately said, this is some kind of Midwestern, let's grab the first black guy we can find. Nobody that knew him fell for this. A, he had the nicest demeanor. B, he left with a different white girl every night. So
he was getting laid.
It's like when those people were saying rape isn't about sex, it must be true, because he had sex all the time. He always had women.
Hey, Ron, how did he finally acquire? I mean, I read something about it was he had some weird ritualistic thing he would say after each rape, and someone connected it on the net.
Well, what happened was this, and it was actually like before the net got bigger, just right about the time. So it was like. It was like that era where, like, you wouldn't put together things as quickly or couldn't get information as quickly. But after he raped them, he had them pray with him. He was wearing, like, a ski mask. They had to pray. But the way that they basically found him is so many of these rapes were taking place in these, like, little colleges in, you know, towns in, like, Nebraska or someplace out there where they didn't have black people. And the cops finally got his calendar. His fucking calendar that he had was showed every night, everywhere that he was on his tour.
That's good evidence.
Perfectly.
But, Ron, what made them suspect him? Do you know?
They were going, how could there be a black guy in this town? What, you know, these are like little, you know, Midwestern Bible colleges. You know, these weren't taking place at like the University of Kansas. These would be like little towns you've never heard of before. And they're going, how could a black guy be here? Did he drive in? Did he? And then they start putting together. Well, you know, remember that was comedy night. Comedy night we had that night, and it's fucking just. It was the worst. Stupidest thing that, you know, crime that you could have done when you're the black guy.
How many women did he rape?
You know, I don't remember the whole thing, but it literally was a string. I mean, I remember it made all the news stories and shit like that. So it was a big enough thing that it got out there as, you know, making the news.
Man.
So it was, you know, when you get called serial, you've been doing it for a little while.
Yeah, true.
But I don't know. Man. I guess they tied it back to, you know, he had some strict upbringing, blah, blah, blah. I don't know.
That whole pray with me thing is so, like, weird.
Yeah.
You rape a woman and then you hit pray with me.
That's some bullshit.
Like this happened to both of us.
Yeah, yeah.
Instead of going and cleaning up and trying to put this out of your mind, now get on your knees next to me.
Yeah,
I'll pray. You're not going to be going to the hospital for a rape kit.
Yeah, because now I need comfort, not you. Yeah.
But Jesus. I swear to God, you would have said later, like, if you didn't know the truth, you would have went on the fucking stand for the guy and said this could never have happened.
That's amazing. Was he a funny guy?
Nah, he was fucking terrible. But, you know, he was black and he was nice to people. You know, like, hey, how's everyone doing? I know, I'm the only black guy. You know, he would really lean on that. I'm the only black guy, so the fucking, you know, normal people would just giggle and go on and, you know, feel like, oh, this is relaxing. You know, he would do, like, self-depreciating black guy jokes, and you know how people love that.
Oh, yeah.
And
yeah,
later he would rape them. Now who's laughing? Now what's the fucking joke?
Yeah.
Terrible.
Fucking
great.
So Ronnie, you knew him for a long time, or like, because Ronnie, I drew the drawers in studio.
Yeah,
he knew Ronnie on the comedy club.
Yeah, I knew him for a lot of years, and you know, never a problem. Real professional guy. Used to help the other comics get into different clubs around the country, everybody, but nothing but good things about the guy.
How long did he get?
Have no idea who people are.
How long did he get? Yeah. You know,
I know it was like, you know, decades. I don't know if they kept him all that long. Cause this had to be over about 10 years now.
So he's probably still in jail.
Yeah, he should be. I mean, wow. I can't imagine ever feeling fucking safe around the guy again. Because, like, how are you going to rehabilitate him when nobody saw it happening? You know, it's not like he was running through town fucking frothing at the mouth.
Right.
Wow.
Yeah, wonder if he's working on his act.
I know.
In jail.
Because that would be a good hook. Nowadays, that really would work.
Yeah. Redeemed rapist having 20 minutes.
Rapist.
With all the time he has, he should come out as the greatest comic ever.
The greatest comic rapist in the history of mankind.
This was honestly like, he was trying to be like the black Brian Regan. Like, if you know how, you would never believe he did anything wrong. You know.
Well, Regan's got his dark side.
We all know that.
You know. Boy. I'd love to talk about some nights out with Regan.
Oh, Regan could go nuts. I've seen him once have 2 Amstel lights.
Is that it? I remember walking out of a bar, and it was daylight out. And we had just been drinking all night long. And he was hysterical. But it was nothing he would ever do on stage. I love the guy.
Hey, Ron, you interviewed Regan for Unmasked, didn't you?
Yeah, just recently, and here was the weird thing. Like, we invited the audience in from BrianRegan.com. And you know how, like, Brian could come into any of your events and everybody loves him and all? His fans, his real fans, you guys would be shocked of what they look like. It's such a after-church social thing. It's the scariest thing you've ever seen. They're the whitest, calmest people in history.
Really?
Yeah. Threw me.
How are they taking the interview and stuff? Were they getting offended?
They thought everything was wonderful. Thank you
good.
Much. I'm not even kidding you. They brought their children.
Oh, God.
Wow.
Yeah.
How
Everybody
great would it be to hear...
They brought their kids in a covered dish here.
Hold on, we got James.
It would be great, though, if he's being interviewed with Ryan, and he's like, you know, the problem is the Jew.
The Jews. They run this business, Ronnie.
Hey, we got Jay Moore on the line, too. We got Ronnie, and now we got Jay Moore. What's up, Jay?
I just wanted Ron Bennington to know that I'm calling Opie.
Yeah.
I get you guys back together.
No,
yeah, Ron's been trying.
We packed everything up. We're like old girlfriends. We did a couple skate the other night.
Did we ever have a problem?
I know. What was there to patch up?
Just, every time I talk to Richard Fez, he's like, you got to talk to OBJ. You have to mend this fence. You got to mend the fence.
That's what Ronnie does.
I love Jay.
What?
I love you.
What comic are you talking about? It's making me nuts.
Vince Champ?
Yes.
Oh, what a douchebag black comic name that is. You know what? It could only be worse if he was Vince Champ the Third.
Probably was.
Oh, they are awful. Have you ever noticed how goofy white people are? They're so silly.
When you rape them.
Yeah. You ever notice how a white woman cries when her face is being kicked in?
Oh, yeah. They're hilarious. The only white people that talk the way black comics make white people sound is Bryant Gumbel. Hi, everybody. How are you? I'm a white guy. Really? Are you Greg Gumbel? Fucking black guy.
And they do the walk.
Yeah, and if the white man's holding you back, wouldn't you give me a scarier voice than that?
Yeah, like, how does a white man hold back black people by talking like this?
Yeah, we kind of laugh at that.
Hi, honey. Honey, I'm home.
That's the guy that's fucking keeping you from getting the corner office, the retarded guy that can't walk? Jesus Christ, you fucking ignorant black asshole. Make me sound like a pilot or something spooky.
Yeah, that is a...
Give you the promotion.
That is a great observation. They do have the worst imitation of a white guy. We laugh at that.
We're completely accurate on our...
Oh, absolutely.
Imitations of black people.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah.
Well, I never called the plug. May I plug something?
Please.
Yes, please.
Jimmy, where are you going to be?
I have no gigs, but Jay...
We got Greg Giraldo in the
studio.
Giraldo
is here, and he's doing...
Hi, Greg.
Hey, Jay, how you been?
I'm very well. I haven't seen you since Tough Crowd.
Yeah, I haven't seen you since...
Greg needs to be on television. The guy's just good for the eyeballs. He's just easy on the eyes.
Oh, well, look at you.
Oh, hey.
Listen, all that Vince Champ talk's got me going a little bit, too.
That's nice.
Yeah, like there's never, Greg Giraldo's never going to bother you. You're never like, ugh, this guy. It's always just like, oh, Greg's not good.
Unless you're Carrot Top. Apparently Carrot Top doesn't like Greg.
Yeah, you need to talk to my wife.
Carrot Top's the orange Hulk. Are you laughing at Hulk or his wife?
Orange Hulk.
He looks like the Hulk with jaundice. Hey, I have a webisode up on foxsports.com. I figured all the whackbacks would go and comment on, make fun of me and my wife, because me and my wife football picks on it.
That's what they do.
I heard that they're hilarious. Actually,
yeah, they're really
good
funny.
Job at that.
I will say this. They're pretty damn funny. Hey, how about OJ getting arrested with man boobs?
Wow, he is 60, though.
Well, I don't care if he's 60. He's fucking, he's like Jim Brown, too. He's not Jim Brown the Third, but he's Jim Brown, too. You don't do the perp walk with fucking man boobs. I like what OJ said. What happened in Vegas stays in Vegas. Yeah, it's all like you. You're going to be there for a long time, you fucking dope. Hi, everybody. I'm O.J. Simpson. How are you, fella? Hey, Jimmy, make sure you promote foxsports.com, okay?
That's all I talk about anyway. I'd be happy to. I heard your picks are very good.
I love you. Yeah.
And are you doing this?
Huh?
Are you doing this week's picks?
Hold on. I just went in the tunnel. Say it again.
Are you doing this week's picks?
It's already up and running right now. You can watch it up right now.
That's what
my wife
do.
And I are playing. Whoever wins the pick, my wife is going to bring her actual Catholic school outfit out of storage, like the one she actually wore in high school. If I win, she has to wear it. But it's not like from a costume shop. It's like the actual one she wore when she was 16. And then, but if she wins, I have to wear it. But what she did, the joke's on her, because I'll come. FoxSports.com. See you guys later.
All right, two more.
Jay.
All right, boys. Bye, Ronnie.
See you, man.
Ronnie's still here, I think.
I found out a long time ago.
Yeah, I figured you did, Ronnie.
It's hard to have two people on the phone with Jay on the phone.
He was a bit focused today. We like when Jay's focused.
I just,
it's very rare.
When he calls our show, I just fucking walk away for a while and let him scream stuff.
Very, very rare. What can we expect on the Ron and Fez show today?
Well, Fez hasn't slept in 2 days. So
oh, Jesus Christ.
See how this fence hold up.
Wait, what happened?
Well, we'll see how his health is after not sleeping for 2 days.
Why isn't he sleeping now?
2 days.
I put a little contest to see if I could help everybody focus on the show. I wasn't happy with their focus level, so I had him stay up for a couple nights.
Oh, great.
That helps.
That's really going to do well in that little fucking cracker box you're in for a show.
Yeah, it's really just killing time till the merger. I really think that none of
Yeah, that's what we're all doing.
Yeah.
We are all just killing time until this merger happens or doesn't happen or whatever. What happened the other day? We lost power or something? Somebody cut through a power line over there?
Never have any worries about it. I don't care one way or the other. Whether I'm on the air or not on the air, it doesn't matter.
Just go and do a show.
Talk the same way as I'm talking to you guys now. It doesn't matter.
Yeah. You're a professional. You're a consummate professional.
Well, I'm just going to get a stealing money.
It's going to be it's going to get interesting the next 3 months, I think.
Yeah.
We'll see.
I'm going to pay very little attention to it and just ignore the whole thing.
God, I'm with you, man. You can't be bothered anymore and worry about this crap.
I just call Bob up and go, how much do they owe me? If they don't want to do anything else, they want me to leave, how much do they owe me right now?
God damn. That's the way to look at it. Because if this merger goes through, Mel Karmazin's going to be the head muckety-muck. Then you're going to have to deal with that.
My thing is to have zero ambition. That's exactly where I want just to not care about any of it.
Zero ambition.
Zero ambition. Like that. It's the same as the love for my kids. I expect nothing, and if anything comes up, just seems really interesting, then enjoy it.
All right there, Ronnie.
All right,
let
boys.
You go and listen to a Ron and Fez after us.
At noon.
You're on 202.
I'm out every day there, Ron.
Yeah, I'm glad I could tell the story of old Vince Champ, the rapist from the 90s.
And the funny part, I was saying before, is they kept showing his Evening at the Improv set. Like, if you're on trial, the last thing you want is just that shitty set being representing you on television.
Hi, everybody. Hi, everybody. All right, take care, boys.
All right, see you later. Later, Ronnie.
There's no way
Ronnie
to keep B. your no way to keep your street cred when fucking when Bud Friedman and that stupid monocle is calling you.
Oh, the monocle.
Yeah.
All
your
right.
set is so bad that even after being a serial rapist, you're still considered sort of soft and unintimidating. He's an unthreatening. Soft, unthreatening.
He's like Sinbad with rape.
We'll take a quick break. When we get back, we challenged Renee, remember, to find something funny? She brought something funny to the show today.
Oh, good.
What'd she bring that we thought was just... she thought the Scott and Todd song parody was funny.
Yeah.
Yesterday, right?
Yeah,
so we said, look,
really bad.
Your homework assignment is to bring something in that you think is funny.
Mm-hmm.
And I hold that in my hand. We'll play it for everybody next. Mm-hmm. And Than went over the sitcom Back to You.
Oh, no.
It's sitcom season.
Customer.
I think Greg Giraldo is going to enjoy this unless you have to leave.
Nah, anything to do with a sitcom, I'll always love.
Yeah, this is Than's gig. He loves doing this.
We make Than watch sitcoms.
Cool.
And then he points out some interesting
he
things.
He takes out the hilarious parts for us.
Yeah.
The parts that just are the money makers. Yeah, the knee slappers, the part that the audience just guffaws.
And we prepare the audience by saying, folks, pull over and put on those laughing hats.
Right.
We really enjoy this segment with Than. So
strap yourself.
We're bringing it back in. We're bringing it back to the show because, the new shows have begun this fall here. It's Opie and Anthony.
All I want is to get laid and eat sandwiches. That's it.
That's the closest reference you can get to something cool, hip, and groovy. Cool,
wow.
Hip, and groovy.
Dick.
Yeah.
Where do you go when your wife changes the locks?
The Opie and Anthony Show.
I want to be on you.
Well, you've come to the right place.
I help you, you help me, we all laugh.
Don't worry, we're not listening because this is a boring conversation.
Love you too, sweetness.
If you walk past him, they'll take your jewelry, you take your purse or whatever,
You have no idea what they are.
There are a lot of questions about them.
Real.
Dirty looking.
Thinking on.
Shut up. Bring on the booze.
Is this the Obie and Anthony Show? Okay.
Ah, where's Renee?
Jack, Renee.
Jack M is today's complainer. And yet, what's another 20 minutes of radio followed by a break, only to leave promptly at 11. I reiterate, fuck you guys.
Shut the fuck up.
You're lucky we go to 11.
Not you, Jimmy. Not you.
I swear to God, you're lucky we go to 11 because we don't even have bosses at XM right now. We can leave at 10 and no one's going to tell us, you know, guys, we've noticed that you've been leaving at 10. You know, the contract states you got to be there at least till 11.
Yeah.
I swear to God, we'll do it tomorrow. I'll prove my point. We'll leave nice and early tomorrow. And guess what? We're not going to get one phone call about it.
Exactly. So fuck off.
Renee, how are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Greg Giraldo? You know him?
Hi, yeah. Renee.
She
doesn't know much. That's why I said
I don't know much. I don't know anything.
Did we ever? We never made out or anything, did we?
No.
No.
No, we're good.
Okay, cool.
Yeah.
Would you make out with him?
We ever forced to pray with someone after a comedy show?
Yeah. You look prayerful. You look like you need to meet Jesus.
Oh, no. I'm not going down that road.
No?
Do you find him attractive?
Jesus?
Yes. Jesus is hot.
Would you give Jesus a hand job if he was willing? I think I would. It's not gay if it's the Lord.
No.
As long as I'm not going to hell.
Yeah, I'm going to help.
Why would you go to hell? I think he'd appreciate that.
I don't know.
So we told you to bring in something funny.
Yes.
So what did you bring us?
I found this video a while ago, but I kind of ignored it. So I saw it this morning and acted quick. And it's a kid in Walmart just picking up the phone over the PSA and... PA, sorry. And just seeing Baby Got Back. I thought that was funny.
Spoiler alert.
I like turtles.
Spoiler alert.
I like turtles.
All right. Well, let's take a listen. This is what Renee finds funny, Anthony.
Okay. I like big butts and I cannot lie. You other brothers can't deny. When a girl walks in and anybody wasting around thing in your face, you get sprung. Want to pull up front because you noticed that butt was stuck.
Excuse me.
No? I thought it was to play with.
No, it's not.
Okay. Sorry.
Let's go around the room.
All right.
Well, Jimmy threw his mic away.
He's got his head
in his hands.
Oh, man.
Jimmy? Comment?
Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, man.
All right. Well,
I'm trying to think of a situation in which I could even laugh with that playing somewhere in the country.
What? Why is it funny?
Because it's just, I thought it was funny. A kid going into Walmart, he has nothing better to do with his life. It's pretty sad, actually. And singing Baby Got Back.
Wait. Why would he have nothing better to do with his life? Maybe he just happened to be in the store and he was looking for something and then said, well, while I'm here, maybe I'll have a little fun with the PA because I see it's right over there.
He could do that, but I'm thinking to myself, what gives you this idea that you have to go into Walmart and...
To make a video and put it up on...
Cause some ruckus.
On YouTube.
There you go.
Yeah. That's why he did it. So boy, you're on the hot seat, huh?
Oh, this is burning right now.
No, Renee raised a good point. She's like, I thought it was funny, and I'm like, why? And then she just kind of reiterated what the video was. Well, because I went on to Walmart, and he sang Baby Got Back.
Why not? It's just funny. I thought it was funny. I laughed, and there you go. I did my homework.
And there you go.
Did I get an A?
Oh, is that it?
I wouldn't read instant feedback anytime video. Soon. Redding from Whackbag. Holy shit. Of all the videos online, she found that one funny? Well, there's a part two.
No, wait, we're watching it now.
Okay.
All right, see, now I couldn't see it before the guy's
Oh, there he goes.
And he's got curly hair. So it's just like, it's a really fat guy with curly hair who doesn't make me laugh. On any level.
Well, there's more, Jimmy. There's more. He tries it again on another phone.
All right, I didn't know
that. Attention, shoppers. You're in for a special treat. I like big butts and I cannot lie. You other brothers can't deny. When a girl walks in and then anybody wakes in and runs in, you up that you get wrong. Want to pull up broke and runs that butt with stuck. Deep in the spring, you swear. I'm hooked and it gets up there. And ooh, baby, I want to get with you and take your picture. Homegirl was trying to warn me, but that's...
His friend with the camera finds it funny.
I thought it was funny.
You folks fell on your face. You get an F minus in my book.
That's the kind of thing that pilots on JetBlue do now. You know?
Yeah,
they're always trying to be so funny all the time on JetBlue.
Yeah, just shut the mic off. Yeah, and fly the fucking plane.
I hate to say this.
That's funny?
I wouldn't say, I mean, she's fucking panning it like it's a Peter Sellers film. But I didn't, once watching it and then he did it again, it's just this fat, obnoxious idiot. It doesn't suck. Like, it is kind of amusing. It's not hilarious.
The video's funnier than just hearing the audio.
Yeah, because just watching a guy make that noise is shit. But, I mean, when you're just watching a real fat kid in the store just being a dick, I kind of appreciate that.
Yeah, but there's 8,000 of those up on any video site. Like,
probably
where
so, yeah.
It's kind of funny, but you need to watch the video.
A Java Wheel from Boston. She better be hot, because this video sucks. Yeah, I guess that's why you get a pass. You know that. If you're ugly, we would have booted you a long time
ago. Well, if I was ugly, would I be out of here the first day?
Not the first day.
No, the other one we have in here. you get that one 5-year-old Iraqi kid with tits.
Yeah. Oh, my God.
Wow, Jimmy.
Oh, my God. Oh, Jesus.
So I guess I have more work to do.
We don't even know what you do. You just look good around the hallway. So
come on.
You just continue.
What do you do? And don't say the bagel and club soda.
That's
nothing.
No, I'm doing production. Sam helped me out with the video today.
Oh, did you, Sam?
Yes, he did. I'm, again, looking for stuff, looking for video, audio, anything possible for the show. Mm-hmm. Articles.
So the whole time you've been here, have we ever used anything that you've come up with?
Yes. What was the first one? The mystery, the guess the sound. It was the guy with the fetish.
Oh, yeah, that was pretty good, actually.
Well, that was good. Okay.
Yeah, that was
kind of
good.
Do look like alfalfa. One.
Oh, come on.
No.
A little bit. Freckles?
A little bit.
Nothing sticks up?
No.
Oh, that's a good... She's very pretty, but you're hot as alfalfa. There's something very weird about that.
Yeah, you'd be like a cute alfalfa Schweitzer. It's better than being a cute Spanky.
Jesus. God.
Well, Jay from Florida writes, other things Renee finds funny include AIDS, starving children, and comedy shows on the CW. So you're in good company there.
Oh, well, whatever.
There's a picture of alfalfa.
Russ from Alabama.
Stupid picture.
That's terrible.
Russ from Alabama. Hot Renee has a stinky stink knuckle. And then he writes, you see, I linger longer.
What? And that's a stupid picture, though, of me up there. I don't know who took that. Oh, yeah, Craig.
Oh, really?
What do you mean you don't know who took it? It's obvious you're posing for it.
Yeah.
It's not like it was the paparazzi. And they got a lens on, a camera, and a bush.
I forgot who took it for 2 seconds. He just started shooting at whatever he could, and I knew they would put up a stupid picture. I knew they would do that.
It doesn't, I'll say it, it doesn't show you as nicely as it could have shown you. I think that you look a lot better than that photograph
Thank
would
you.
Indicate you look.
Well, Phil from Long Island writes, lung cancer is funnier. And Bill K from Philly, Renee should be traded to the Canadian Comedy Channel for a bag of sand.
Oh, thanks. Appreciate that one.
Why? She likes clips of guys in the Walmart, and it didn't suck. I mean, after watching a little bit, I was like, it's all right.
All right.
It's like, no disrespect, but it's like, I probably wouldn't laugh at that if I watched
right.
it. That's not my sensibility, but I could see a girl finding that kind of...
Making a sort of geo-social political statement, too.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Walmart, its accessibility to the masses.
It's my homework. I found something funny. You didn't say what you guys thought was funny. You said what I thought was funny, right?
She turned around on us.
Yeah,
there.
No, we
you're
wanna,
right, you're
we
right.
We want to know what you find funny, and that's what you brought to us.
I thought that was like a stupid funny.
All right, well, Dave in Philly writes, she found that clip so funny, her ass is leaking.
Yeah.
You got a leaky ass because of that?
No.
Still trying to figure out that.
Yeah, I didn't get that.
All right. Should we have her bring in something else?
Absolutely.
Else?
This is all your right. new bit, so you got
all
a
right.
bit now.
Sounds good.
Yeah.
We need another one tomorrow, but save that one for tomorrow as well.
Yeah.
We got to replay that for everybody.
I'd like to have all a right. copy of that to bring home in case I get sad. I throw it in.
It'll good. Pick you up.
I thought
you'd be laughing and laughing.
I did my job.
Yes, you did.
Yeah.
Very good.
Okay. So it's like a C, a B.
Oh, you want
a grade.
Letter grade?
I did just want a grade.
I'd give a B to the C.
I have to give it a, honestly, a D.
Okay.
I have to give it a D.
Okay.
You got to start somewhere.
It's like a C.
C, I agree.
C? Why would you give it a C?
It's
Because if it was only that one thing, I would have thought it sucked. But after watching it the second time where he's like, he goes to another PA and his stupid friend is left, like, I would, it wasn't that bad. It's like, just it's just a kid being a douchebag in a store. I'd never seen it before, so.
Mm.
Okay, it's funny. Big fat kid just singing.
Yeah, Blue Heeler from Kentucky, that wouldn't even be funny with a smoker's laugh on it.
I'll give it a C.
Say, Greg?
A plus.
Oh, thanks.
Oh, wow. Yeah. That really
is what you were
brings the average up.
The democratization of the PA system.
Yeah.
Oh,
that was funny. What would you give the fetish one?
That was good.
Oh, yeah. That's definitely
that killed two guys.
A.
All right. I got to find more.
Yeah.
I'm not going to stick with the fetishes. I'm going to go a different way, but
okay.
I'll find something.
Great.
Yeah.
Right. You you're working.
Not going to stick with the fetishes. What do you mean?
Well, I wasn't going
to,
you know.
She doesn't want to be a one-trick pony.
They stick with the same thing.
Okay.
Gotta take a different route.
I'm just watching a little Maury. He's on TV, and he's got extreme teen videos. And some guy just got cracked across the back with a big piece of wood.
By the way,
bleeding.
The girls on Pal Talk don't like you.
They don't like me?
Pal Talk, French Bread Pizza writing, F for the hair. A cups for the chest.
What?
Who cares?
Hey, I'm just reading them, man.
Amy,
the girls aren't liking you is what it comes down to.
I think that they're probably...
A little jealous?
A little threatened by Renee.
Yeah.
Maybe.
And there's nothing wrong with A cups.
No, they're fantastic.
I got nothing. I don't care.
No, it's, you don't want... Believe me, you don't want... Don't get fake tissed.
No.
Keep the A cups.
I get my A's.
Yeah. Sometimes you wish your girl would never grow up.
Uncle Paul.
You had to rub Earl on him.
Earl.
Put a little Earl on Monday.
A little warm Earl.
They don't have to like me. I don't care.
All right.
I think they're a little jealous of you because you're very popular in the studio and everybody likes you.
Because I'm sitting here and they're there?
That's probably it.
And every intern wants you.
Oh, that's
and probably
not
half
true.
The staff.
The interns are all.
Not true.
The interns are all after.
Every are they single, really?
Oh my god!
No, they're not.
All the guy interns
no,
in the intern
not.
Party room.
Pat Duffy. Oh, Pat Duffy. No.
I love how you walk past that room and she's just like, and then and everyone's like, really? Tell
they're
us
all
more.
Like listening.
It's like the most interesting thing they've ever heard
it's
in their
like
lives.
Pesci and Goodfellas.
They're
killing every time you walk.
Yeah, their acting is horrific, and she's just babbling away, and they're all just like. Really focused on what she has to say.
Who the hell is this?
I don't know. How about this kid in fucking Jake LaMotta's slippers?
So, who are you, sir?
I'm the new guy. I'm Patrick.
New guy, Patrick.
Do you like Renee?
Howdy. Huh? Not in that way, no.
Why?
What she's taller than me. I'm kind of
exactly.
short.
Is that a problem?
It really narrows it down on women you can fuck
it
then.
Does.
Jesus, you're a little fella.
That's never a problem.
No.
I don't mind. Like, you can't have a giant woman, but if a woman's, like, tall... That's pretty cool.
How tall are you, Renee?
5'8".
That's good.
That's getting up to the...
Give him a hug and they're like the same size.
How tall are you?
Got to squat down and
me?
Pick him up
like
a
five,
baby.
5'6", 5'7".
Aw. 5'6", that's a cute little...
don't stretch come out right here. You could just say 5'6". It's okay. Don't pump it up.
People asking where they can find the picture of Renee. It's on 92.3... What's the website again? 923krock.com. 923krock.com.
Look how
go
she's...
to the Opie and Anthony page and the Opie and Anthony updates, which are great.
Look at how she's squeezing her clit by tightly crossing her legs, is what somebody's saying on Pal Talk.
Was, they don't like you.
They every little
they
thing you're doing.
Bite me.
There you go.
You know
bite
mom.
Her.
You don't like me? I don't really don't give a shit.
Yeah.
I don't care.
Bite me. Fucking Renee.
I am sitting here working my ass off, and you are there getting mad at me. I don't care.
Wow.
Those
are fighting words.
And that's the way it is.
Let's say hi to Ken in PA. Ken, what's up?
Hey, I wanted to ask Renee if the world is round or flat.
World, round or flat?
It's round.
All right. She answered right away, too.
May not belong on the view, but we're good.
All right. Very good. All right, Renee.
Let's tell him that time and space is all a myth anyway. And he can...
Oh, God.
So what do you do?
Me?
Yeah.
I watch them work.
Yeah.
Run for bagels.
Have you gotten your hands into anything as far as radio-related stuff yet?
Not really.
No, you haven't brought anything to the table yet?
No.
How long have you been here?
This is my fourth day, I believe.
Fourth day?
Wow. Yeah,
and you want a career in radio?
We'll see. It's the first time I try it.
You guys have the most committed staff, huh? Lord.
Craig, let me explain. A week in, these interns realize what a waste of fucking time this is. They're fetching like coffee and bagels and fruit. Like,
and that's supposed to teach them about radio.
Yeah, I thought I was going to learn about radio, not learn what Opie and Anthony like to eat in the morning.
I want to know what your ultimate goal is, besides being a centerfold in Cavs Monthly.
Cavs Monthly. Thank you for reminding me. My subscription's almost up.
Right.
My kid's got Cavs. Jesus.
Cavs Monthly.
What do you do in your spare time? Just carry safes?
God damn it, Jimmy.
Oh, wow.
So do you want to be on the radio? Is that like your goal?
Just starting. I guess production's all I'm looking for right now.
Yeah. You don't have a goal, though? You aren't like, you know, here's what I want to do. I want to be on the air. I want to do a show, or I want to produce. Or
I sort of shotgun this whole thing.
Really?
I got the internship.
Do the same thing to your head. You got the intern what? On a dare?
On a Monday. And then I decided to do it. And by Friday, I was moved in New York. I was doing construction up until like 2 weeks ago.
Hey, I like a guy like this.
You moved to New York for an internship?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Are you disappointed?
What were you doing? Well, you go to school, obviously, right?
Yeah, I had to sign up for a college after I got the internship.
So you got an internship, and then you had to go to school, so you started going to school after the internship.
Sorry, I have a degree, so I had to re-enlist to community college in Manhattan.
And what classes are you taking? Like,
total joke classes.
Is it anything to do with broadcasting?
I took an intro to broadcasting, but I actually dumped it because it was so terrible. I couldn't stand the teacher. He was late for class, and he was lying. He was just making up
All right. E-Rock. E-Rock's teaching the class. He's late and a liar.
Who screens these guys?
Oh, this is great. So
I thought these guys.
I thought everybody wanted. I thought these were like coveted jobs. You know, people were dying to get radio jobs.
There's something else going on with this guy that he decided to move to New York for an internship, even though he's out of college.
Right. Yeah.
Who are you obsessed with on this show?
Oh, no one. It's just, I did construction with my parents' company for 3.5 years.
Well, you just had it with that, right?
And he's retired. And it was either continue the business or just get out of it. And I wanted nothing to do with it, so I just...
What type of construction, my friend?
Metal stud framing, drywall.
All day long with those fucking drills.
I wish I did that. I was doing insulation 8 hours a day.
Ah, that's good, too. Yeah, that shit makes you itch.
Yeah. Hey, can I jump in fast? Ricky Murphy from Massachusetts, maybe line of the day. The world might be round, Renee, but you're flat.
Oh, wow.
Burn, yeah.
That ain't even, you know...
There's something going on. The listener's not enjoying Renee.
They're really jealous.
She doesn't care.
Patrick is from Whackbag Entry. Patrick's covering his heart on, is what they're saying. They're just looking at the pictures on Pal Talk, the video, and picking you guys apart.
You gotta remember, you're always on camera in this studio.
Covering his heart on. It was a very defensive stance you had there. Covering your heart on.
Do you ever masturbate thinking of Renee?
No.
Tell me the truth.
But it's only the second time I get introduced to her. So
oh, really?
Maybe tonight after everyone's yelling at her.
Spank
Hell
bubble.
No.
Really?
Definitely not.
You don't want him like doing that.
You can't
thinking
stop
of you.
That.
You probably are in.
I probably can't. But I'm just like.
What do you mean you probably can't?
Guys
if he
have
wants to think about
spank,
it tonight and yep spank it. You can't stop.
Guys
that
have spank Rolodexes. And let me assure you, you are in the other interns like Rolodex. So they go through and they like picture maybe. Oh, you're in the hallway, and then you go into the green room and shut up because they got to be detailed. And then like you lay down on the couch, and then it just progresses from there to this. Point where, yeah, he's just working.
Yeah.
Next
yeah,
thing
yeah
you know, you're rolled up in insulation being dragged into the basement.
Yeah. He's trying to fit in two calves. Calves
monthly. That's what he masturbates to, not even having sex with you, that he's just brushing his calves over your face. And you're holding them like the giant turkey legs and worshiping them. God, they're like bowling pins.
Still gonna look for Cavs Monthly on the newsstand.
Oh, yeah, wow.
Yes. He's always on his tippy toes. He wears knickers even in the winter to show them off.
Always reaching for something high up on a shelf.
Always.
Yes.
Let me get it.
Off those calves.
All right, Renee, thank you. And
you're
yes
welcome.
Patrick, is it?
Patrick? Yes. Might actually remember that now.
Sam, yeah, have you ever scrapped to Renee?
No.
Pat Duffy, have you ever scrapped to Renee?
Duffy's scrapped to everybody in this room. Everyone.
Right, scrapping right now.
Oh.
Have you ever scrapped to Renee vomiting or shitting on you?
Here comes Pat Duffy.
Pat.
The star of the Virus Tour with a video.
Hello. Yeah. What's up?
Did you ever scrap to Renee?
No. All I have to say about Renee is that her and I had our run-ins together before this internship started, and it wasn't worth going back to.
Wow. What does that mean?
She's red.
I am probably... Am I
really? Why running?
Renee and I attended the Connecticut School of Broadcasting together.
Ah.
In the same class.
The
so.
Great Connecticut School of Broadcasting.
Yeah. Yes.
So
what run-ins? Negative or positive?
Positive.
So yeah. You guys maybe went out on a couple of dates.
We were seeing each other, yeah.
You were seeing each other.
Oh, okay.
How far did you guys get?
Not very far.
You were seeing Patrick Duffy.
How far?
It was... I'm sorry, Pat, go ahead.
No, by all means.
It was before all of this.
Yeah.
And...
Obviously.
Well, yeah. Yeah.
Hold on.
Go ahead.
Did you you guys made out?
Yeah.
Did you enjoy kissing her?
Yeah.
Did you enjoy kissing Pat?
My only complaint about Renee is that she wears way too much chapstick. So by the time you're done making out with her, you have lip protection as well.
Exactly, yes.
I like
that. Bullshit.
And it didn't bother you, Renee, but he'd have to come by and pick you up in his Amish buggy.
Yes, indeed.
No, he never picked me up. Ever.
She came to me.
Well,
oh God!
Yeah.
Don't try to sound cocky. She came to me. I didn't have a vehicle.
No.
Wait, I'm sorry. Not to. Can I ask you? No. Can I put Pat here so I can see Pat as we're talking to him? Not to douche you, man. I just can't see.
Basically, that means you didn't have much to offer the show.
No, he's good.
But Jimmy didn't want to say that.
Pat gets another Pat takes over.
I want Pat and Renee together so I could talk to me. It's easier. So I didn't know that you guys dated. So you kissed a little bit.
A little bit.
Did you ever brush your hands, say, over his genitals through his trousers?
No.
It didn't go far, like, to the point of,
Renee's
of
a good
any
girl.
Real sexuality.
Yeah. No, not really.
No.
Pat?
Dry humping?
Renee, I, you have brushed your hand over my shorts.
Did no, I? I don't even
shit.
Know.
Remember
exactly.
That night? Do you remember? Yeah. You remember that night you came over to my house and we were together in my bed?
Yes.
There was a lot of touching that
yes.
went on that day.
Whoa.
Yes.
So, and that was the night, by the way, that you did drive to me. And I might as well say it now. I had hooked up with my ex-girlfriend that same night. Just so you know.
Oh, okay. Whatever.
What a fucking trooper. Yeah.
Wait. Slow this down. Hold on.
Why are you
hold on. The
this,
same
Pat
night
Duffy?
She was in your bed, you ended up with your ex-girlfriend later on? Or
no. See, my ex-girlfriend was the one that I've told you guys about. Was at my house. And then she went home because she had to get up early. And I was still feeling rather randy, if you want to use those dumb words. So I called Renee up, and she came over from her house. And then I finished my deed, and that was it.
Wait a minute. So you fucked your ex?
Yes.
You dumped?
Yes.
And then Renee comes over.
And Renee comes over, and we just kind of had, like, this little hookup.
It wasn't
serious.
Did your dick come out?
No. But it was really for my own personal, because I wanted to hook up with two girls in one night. So I was like, I wonder if I could do this. So I did.
Had you gone down on your ex-girlfriend?
No, I don't think so. Uh-huh. I generally didn't do that too much to her.
Disgusting, huh?
Well, no. She actually
just
wasn't
that hole inside. Where a cock should be.
Well, yeah.
Yeah. It was missing something, yeah.
Now that I think about it, I'm not even mad.
You shouldn't be.
Wow.
Do you still have something for Pat?
No.
Good.
No. Right Why? Now, I can't be bothered.
How did it break? How did the whole thing end?
Oh, can I share that?
Please.
Yeah. Okay. Well, I found out, he kind of grew on me after a while, and I was like, all right, I kind of like him, so I wanted to take it to the next level, and all of a sudden,
Next level means you wanted to have sex with him.
No.
Just get things, get to know him a little more, go out, maybe a little more exclusivity.
Right.
Licking of the balloon knot.
No.
Just trying to figure out what the next level
no,
is there.
No, pretty much when Anthony's
go to a malt.
Yeah.
Yeah,
and get a malt.
Did you want to give Duffy a two-knuckler?
Absolutely not. No. No. But anyway, I found out through MySpace that he got back together with his ex-girlfriend.
And that pretty much ended
it. And that pretty much ended it. And
if you were a fan of our show, you would have found out too, but you didn't listen to our show before.
Mm-hmm.
That's right. He was discussing that on our
show. So what do you do now? Like, are you seeing anyone?
I'm not seeing anybody. I don't plan on seeing anybody.
Turned you off to guys.
No, not at all. Not at all.
Hey, Pat,
he's a good kid.
Does your current girlfriend know this is, like, someone you used to be with?
No.
Oh, she does now.
Fuck.
Hey, and let's bring her in. Bring her in now. It's old dog shit kisser. You're a hit on the video on the Virus Tour, I gotta tell you.
Major hit.
When you kiss Pat Duffy after he brushed his teeth with dog shit. The crowd goes wild.
Yeah.
Yes, they did.
Yeah.
She doesn't seem thrilled to be here. Why?
I was working. In the middle of working.
Oh, well, That's, you know, Pat, of course.
Of course.
That's Renee. Yeah. They used to hook up.
Okay.
They used to, like, be kind of, nothing really happened. It wasn't like, you don't got to worry about, you know, if she had chlamydia.
Yeah.
That you got to
awesome.
Get it. Although I don't think she could have chlamydia.
Yeah, basically, tell you the truth. Basically she's a prude, so you have nothing to worry about.
No, I wouldn't call her a prude. She's just selective.
She's a size queen and an anal queen.
Great. Now, did you know that one evening, Pat Duffy...
Months ago.
Wait, this has nothing to do with her. Because I don't want her freaking out. It's another ex.
Had sex with an ex-girlfriend.
Okay.
And then invited her over right after that.
I did not know.
Isn't that kind of a...
I just found out, too.
That's kind of a tells you about his character a little.
A lot of it.
Yeah.
That's cool.
And you're fine, yeah.
It's as long as I'm not involved.
Wasn't you, right?
Cool.
Yeah, that's
whatever happened happened.
That's what they said about the Jews, and then they came for this, and then they came for, and when they came for me, no one was left to
right.
You know what? Something like that. I don't pay attention to much of it. I like the other side's speeches. They're all pomp and circumstance. It was a lot more fun to watch.
The other side's speeches are a lot more passionate.
Yeah, a lot more passionate. To them. They're a lot more memorable.
I think she's cuter.
Who?
Thank you.
Really?
I appreciate that, Obi.
I agree.
I find Renee a little more attractive.
Really?
Yeah.
Jimmy, it's up to you.
I'll be very honest.
They're very different types.
Facially, it's very hard to pick.
Look at her smile. See, she's got a great smile.
Here's how you do it. Do this.
Jimmy's making the universal mouth of the blowjob.
Oh, I thought he wanted them to sing opera.
Oh,
I didn't know it was a blowjob.
It's hard to pick. They're both very, very.
That's why I said that, Renee. It's, you know,
it's very hard to tell, especially if you go by taint.
But she's got bigger boobs, though.
Pat's girlfriend.
I don't need bigger boobs. I like.
What are you talking about? The bigger boobs? Who cares?
What do with that?
I mean, don't go to HR, please.
All right, cool.
Puff and stuff. What the hell can he do? Big stuffed fucker. He's probably not even flame retardant. He'd go up in a second.
Pat's girlfriend shows a little less in the sense that, not that you dress like a whore, but you wear like a little bit of a looser clothes. So I can't see Pat's girl as well. I'd certainly love to as you walk by, just look at you.
The bathroom? 5 minutes?
Oh, yes. But I mean, it's hard to judge.
What the?
Pat Duffy's girlfriend, she's a trooper. He's the real deal. You guys get along very well.
You look like you're wearing more of a Little House on the Prairie kind of top.
Yeah.
I like this shirt.
You should be hanging with Laura Ingalls.
Yeah. Oh,
Laura
Ingalls.
Can you get me a bolt of gingham next time you swing by?
A bolt of
gingham. Bag of rock salt and a bolt of gingham.
There's a lot of confusion out there. Dave in Manhattan.
Go to the mercantile.
Pat Duffy ate dog shit but didn't eat his ex-girlfriend's pussy.
That's right. Wait a minute.
How awful must that slit have been?
didn't bring that up.
She didn't really like that to be done. And
maybe you were really fucking bad at it.
I don't think so.
Yeah.
No?
No.
Is he bad at it?
I don't like that, to be honest with you.
Okay.
Wow, you just hook up with girls that don't like it.
Who's
you're
the
awful
common
at
denominator?
It. You're awful at it.
Here's what he does. He fucking, instead of like facing her, he goes on the side and eats the pussy like from left to right.
Like corn cob. Corn on the cob.
And he puts tape over the clit because it just bothers him to look at.
It might be the beard getting in the way. Like,
yeah,
just scratching
something.
The hell out of the ear.
There's something going on. What are you doing? You're just fucking eating pussy wrong.
I haven't done it in a long time.
Yeah, how do you eat pussy?
I haven't done it in a long time.
In front of someone you used to date and in front of your current girlfriend.
Like, no woman.
What's your technique?
No woman.
Yeah.
Well, I just haven't done it in a long time. I don't know.
What's your technique?
What's your technique?
I like oh, God.
For real.
Why do I?
Hey, we got a prop or anything?
A prop.
Here's
Jimmy's asshole.
I was just gonna fucking say that.
Of course you are.
Another dick joke by Norton.
I know. It's just another dick joke by me. Oh, and it was a Jimmy asshole joke anyway.
Oh, come on.
The toilet paper tube.
All right.
That's a big fucking.
That's it. Yeah, that's if you want to practice. That's ass.
Make believe it's no noses face.
All right, he just collapsed the roll so it looks more like.
Oh, okay. Now it's a slit.
All right.
Okay.
I like to,
What's, hold on. Let me get a little of this, too.
Yeah. It's got a brand new
I got
video
my little camera that I'm just going to start throwing stuff up on the web. I don't care. All right.
Take the lens cap off.
Let's get a little, Oh, thank you. That might help. I'm a professional. All right.
I like to use two fingers down here in the bottom, and then at the same time, I like to lick the clit while doing it.
So you're just a fucking busybody on a pussy.
I guess so, yeah.
You know, though.
You're trying to get everything done.
And then occasionally I'll use my lower two fingers to tickle the anus.
Oh, you go with the shocker.
Yeah, I like to do that a little bit,
too. You know what you are? You're the fucking one-man band of pussy. He's got cymbals between his legs while he's eating a box.
Monica mounted over here.
There's too much going on there.
Why?
Wait. You do the two fingers and then the tongue on the clit.
And then tongue on the clit. And then like this. And then
that's awful.
It looks like you're playing a harmonica.
Sounds like you got 14 fingers. What are you doing down here? Exactly.
You're eating pussy like someone told you to when you were 15. Like, dude, you got to put two in her fucking pussy, two in her asshole.
There we go.
We got a blow-up doll.
Now we have a perfect example.
All right.
That'll work. Like this.
You go sideways. All right, he's got the two fingers in the blow-up doll.
And then you lick the clit like that.
Two in the pink, one in the stink, as they say.
Yeah, and then at the same time, you just kind of like this.
Wait.
Well, I don't know. I mean, like...
Yes, you do.
Do it slow.
I'm too embarrassed with myself.
If you do it that fast, she's really going to fucking be pissed.
Like this. Just like... Like that, you just flip. Oh. I don't know. You tell me. You're better than I am, probably. I don't know.
We were saying you suck at it, and you said no, and now we have an example here. We have a nice blow-up girl.
She thinks
you suck.
I know. Yeah. She really does.
Now, move that arm and go to it.
All right.
Here we go.
All right, here we go.
The two fingers are in there.
And then you go like that.
Yeah.
And then like that. I don't know how to explain it.
That's not a bad technique, but I think that...
But you just don't like doing it. Why don't you like doing it?
Not that I don't like doing it. The past three girls that I've... Well, not three, but the girls I've been with, they don't like it done.
You're the problem.
Why don't you like it done? The past three girls don't like it done. Wait, we're talking to his girlfriend. Why don't you like it done?
I had it done once and it was horrible. I laughed.
Oh, Pat, you laughed.
You could turn around.
No,
to do it again.
I'd rather.
Okay. Wait, you laughed. Why? Because it tickled?
No, because it was horrible.
It was horrible.
Well, let Pat fucking, you know, give it a shot.
All right.
Give it a shot.
All right.
She's psyched.
Sure, why not? Nobody doesn't like their vagina eaten. Some women can't come from that, but nobody doesn't want their pussy eaten if you eat pussy right. No one. There's no woman that would go get out of there.
I agree with that logic.
Unless she was abused and creeps her out.
Well, I agree with that logic.
Let's go to Renee. Renee?
I'm not going there.
Well, that's not a bad thing. Yeah. Did he do that to you?
No.
No. She wants it known.
Do you like that being done?
Not a fan.
Have you ever had it done?
Good question.
Yeah, I did.
Good question.
Why not a fan?
Because, like, she had bad experience.
Oh, bad experience?
Yeah.
They weren't that good?
How bad could the experience be?
It's like saying, oh, God, I got the worst blowjob ever.
It's like that old pizza joke. How bad could it really be?
Yeah, what was bad about it?
I would rather not go there.
The guy had braces and Parkinson's.
No, it wasn't that. It was just...
It was an uncle?
Ew.
All right.
No, I have images in my head.
God. Was it a boyfriend?
It was someone that I thought I liked, and he turned out to be a complete asshole, and this whole thing, it was just... And I don't like having it done.
That sounds like me.
Mm.
That was very vague.
I know. I'm not going to
leaving it vague.
It would save a lot of effort, though.
Well, Douche Nozzle, you know, he's correct. He writes, the secret to eating pussy is to channel your inner lesbian.
You know
what the secret is not doing it like Pat Duffy, where you feel like you got to do something. You're working a flute. You're doing things, too many things.
All right. Well.
And you got to use your whole goddamn head.
That's right. What do you do? I lick the bottom of the pussy, and with my nose, I go onto the clitoris.
You got to use everything. Your ears, and you got to be able to hold your breath for a long time.
So wait, now, hold on. I have to ask Renee. I know you don't want to talk about it. That's fine. But did he use teeth? Because I've heard girls say that guys have actually, not bitten hard, but have scraped their pussy.
Leave a bite like an apple.
Well, that's what happened to me.
Oh, see?
Use teeth?
Mm-hmm. Teeth? So a guy was eating you, and he used his teeth.
I ate pussy like a werewolf.
He probably went to suck on it, right? Like, sucked the pussy and caught in their teeth. And fucking old clumsy teeth, didn't know what he was doing.
Thinks it's a gummy bear.
Yeah.
Oh, nasty pussy biter.
All right, so you don't like it because some guy didn't know what he was doing.
And bit it.
What did the guy do wrong? You know, without too much details. Did he do that?
I just didn't like it at all.
Didn't like it?
Yeah.
You might have a hang up about that.
Did he say that you smelled?
Like,
no,
I don't think, jeez, fucking Jim, jump into some conclusions there.
No, I'm not.
So, you guys stink?
Yes, dumpster pussy, you're online too. No, but I'm saying, like, a lot of guys don't like, that's not about you, that's a lot of guys just have, are fucking squeamish about shit like that. They don't like it.
Yeah.
So a guy might just smell like a great vagina and go, ugh, yeah, and fucking freaky girl. Like, girls with big pussy lips don't like their pussies because some asshole in high school made fun of them.
Yeah. Pat Duffy, also, now be honest, do you dive right in there with your fingers in your face? Do you, like, go down and go, you know, thwack, boom, faces in?
Oh, you mean, like, full throttle, or do I work up to it?
Well, I know now you're going to say you work up to it. Is working up to it working up to it? Or are you just pretty much getting your fingers in there and getting set like you're ready to bull ride?
Well, yeah, I mean, I guess you could put it like that.
Yeah.
I mean, I actually, not to sound retarded, but I actually don't really understand the scenario you're giving me.
Well, I'm trying to, like, let's just say, you kind of got to work up to it.
Right.
It's a slow process.
Right.
You don't want to start going down on a girl with her knowing, oh, here he goes, he's pulling the old going down on me gag.
Oh, no, I don't think so.
No?
No, I don't know.
Sneak up on him.
Yeah, you got to sneak up on that thing. Really?
He puts his fingers in so bad. Here's what the girl probably hears. He goes, okay, are you going to come soon? And he fucking just spits on it and then slops his fingers again and fucking jams them in, fucking fingernails scraping the inside of the
God.
He's
I'm pretty good with my fingers.
Fingernails. And
I gave you your first orgasm.
Yes.
Wow.
Cool, hold on. Fucking Danny Discreet.
Really? Maybe she didn't want the whole world to know that.
Oh, no, that's cool.
All right. Hey, Stacey's got a shocker story. Stacey, what's up?
Hey, what's going on, Ope? I got a pretty interesting shocker story for you guys. My gynecologist from home would give me the shocker as a normal test.
Uh-huh.
What?
Like,
what's a shocker?
I've never had any other OBGYN do it, but two in the pink, one in the stink, right in every annual exam.
Two in the pink, one in the stink. Wow. Was it the thumb that was one of them?
No. Nope. Index?
No?
In the middle.
Because that doesn't even make sense.
Right,
so I thought maybe they were trying to feel something in there.
Dr. Vince Champ.
Dr. Champ to surgery.
The gynecologist had to pray before she went to
Two in the baby hole, one in the maybe hole.
Great Geraldo.
So wait, sweetheart, he would do this. Would you come?
No. And it was a 76-year-old woman to boot.
Wow.
Ew. Was a fucking charm bracelet with her grandchildren's hand.
Maybe that was just her hand was like arthritically formed that way. She wasn't really.
Her charm bracelet's jingling against the speculum. Did she have a speculum in you while she did this?
That would be a fucking talent and a half.
That is.
Did she explain why she did that?
She never really said anything more than it's just a normal procedure. But because of her age,
at her house,
I wondered. What old practice taught you that you should give women the shocker? Like, what in schooling said, now, when you're testing for pressure in here, and here, you need to make sure that you have two in the pink and one in the sink and yada, yada, yada.
Because there was so much dysentery back then, you never knew when anyone was just going to drop a giant load on the table, so you wanted to make sure to stuff that up.
Yeah, she's that old. I mean, she probably, yeah.
The old cork watch.
Damn. All right, Stacey.
I have to examine your asshole. Smoke this cigarette. It's good for you.
Excellent. People are, thanks, guys.
Remember, gynecology class, one in the stink, two in the pink.
I love that she kept going back to this doctor, though, over and over.
Yeah, after the first time.
3 years. You
a lot of people doing their Larry King impressions on Instant Feedback.
Really?
How important is the clit to pussy eating?
Pussy eating. Pat Duffy, you ever done any pussy eating?
A fair amount.
You're pretty bad at it.
From what
three girls have said, you stink.
All right.
How important is the tongue?
Very important.
Eat that pussy. Eat that pussy now.
Gums.
Wow.
Angry Vince.
And do you go, do you do a few all the way from, I'm talking from asshole up to uppermost part of the the vag?
Yes.
Really, you do that?
Also known as the car wash.
The car wash. Is it those things that hang at the car wash full of suds?
And they're just going, car wash gets everything.
The car wash.
I just invented that.
I love that.
You're a swiper.
That's great. Swiper, no swiper. It'll be now known as the car wash car on this wash. Radio show. God, all sorts of stuff happening. All right, let's say hi to Brad in Tennessee. Brad.
Hey, ONA, what's up?
Hey.
I just wanted to say I like to eat werewolf pussy.
All right, are we done with everybody now? She's awkward. Everyone's awkward.
Yeah, everyone's having like an awkward moment.
Hold on, how did Pat give you your first orgasm?
Yeah, I knew that wasn't going to be left alone.
How could it be? It's fucking
exactly.
Harsh.
By the way, one person in this room is lying.
Ooh.
No doubt in my mind someone in this room is lying.
Who is it?
Not even a doubt in my mind.
All right, I take cock.
Jeez, you got all nervous. You could have kept your poker. You could have kept your poker face for a little longer. We're off the air in 2 minutes.
I mean, what? Oh, Pootie thinks lying.
I have no doubt in my mind someone in this room is lying. But how did you? How did Pat Duffy give you your first
sexual experiences?
Yeah,
I like to pleasure the man.
Ah,
and
she likes to blow me.
Yeah.
All right. See, obviously, Pat's not lying.
Yeah, Pat just.
And she's probably good at it, right?
Very.
Because
holy
she likes
shit.
It. Because
yes.
She likes
wow.
it.
Wow, he goes, very holy shit, he says.
Would you mind if we asked Pat why you're good at it? Pat, why is she good at it?
She has no gag reflex whatsoever, and it's fucking awesome.
Hi.
Jumping Jehoshi fat.
Wow.
You guys are.
Because I like it, so.
That's and you like
she
it.
She really likes it.
That's great.
A whole lot. Which is good for me. Yeah.
That's a keeper.
Why is Jimmy covering his crotch now?
Yeah, Jimmy. Jimmy's now like grabbing. He's filling up.
No, I wouldn't be disrespectful to Pat's girl.
No.
However, if Pat was to be fired soon. No, that's cool. See, that's because you like something. That's probably why that you need a little bit of work on the vag eating, because you do it like as just a way to do something else instead of loving it.
Can you eat her vag tonight and then we'll have a full report tomorrow?
Yeah, I could definitely do that.
Would you mind that?
Put it on YouTube. Weekend, cool.
Huh? Yeah.
Well, we could put it on YouTube.
Yeah, there you go.
Keep your filthy mitts out of it, too. Just use your mouth. Be very soft.
Use right. your mouth.
All right.
You could maneuver around some of the, you know, gadgetry down there with right. various fingers, you know.
Right.
But, you know, you don't go shoving fingers in there like all that. Right. It's just silly.
You know,
it's not that
it's
bad,
just
though,
silly.
Finger thing.
Well, no, not when you're doing like that and you're jamming two in there and
she likes
just
two.
Licking.
Yeah, but, you know,
but she doesn't like the way
you're
eating pussy.
The parts and you're getting it shoved in, you kind of like it. I know you don't have the part, so I can't even...
Well, that's what Opie was saying about the lying. I actually have a vagina.
Must a lot confess. Of people lying. No, if you're going to do the finger thing, you got to do the old, oh, yoo-hoo.
Oh, the come fingers. Hither.
Yeah.
The come hither.
That's the key.
The yoo-hoo.
Oh, yoo-hoo.
Nobody does that.
There's these ridges, you see.
Right, that's
come
the key.
Hither.
That's yeah. the problem ridges. I've been having, too, because I go, beat it. I poke really hard and angry. Get lost.
Well, E-Rock, yes, this is very good. Right after, because Pat Duffy talked about his chick blowing him, we should allow Pat Duffy to promote his mom's flower shop.
Well, absolutely.
Yes.
Oh. Nothing goes hand in hand like blowjobs and flowers.
Yes.
Yeah.
Especially with her mom.
Yes. My mom's flower shop is Krause's Flowers, which is in Clinton, New Jersey.
Krause's.
You can go to krausesflowers.com, K-R-A-U-S-E-S, flowers.com.
So basically
they have,
you're saying
a comments section or message board?
I think you have an email form. You can
email form?
You.
Yeah, you
can. Basically, you're saying,
he likes boy.
Oh, Jesus.
Basically, you're saying to the guys out there, if your girlfriend gave you a great blowjob recently, you should you get your lady some flowers from your mom's shop.
Or
there.
Buy flowers, and I'll give him a blowjob.
You'll give Pat?
Wow.
What? Customers.
Oh.
So for every order that my mom gets, I get a blowjob?
Wait, would you like to see her with another guy in front of you?
No, I'd murder them both.
Really?
Oh, wow. All right, you're at that state. That's good.
I always like to give Pat the money for the flowers. Just do what you will with this, son.
Wow. Awkward.
Renee,
Pat,
ever?
You never hooked up beyond... Okay, that's no, innocent.
Yeah. Renee, ever do what she's proficient at?
No.
No, okay.
You never given head?
Just asking.
To him, no.
No,
to
I mean ever, just
life.
In general.
I'm not going to go there.
All right.
She's the one who's lying.
I think.
Wow.
Wait, Renee,
Pat.
How old is Renee, 23?
Yeah.
So are you kind of, not, are you a little inexperienced with sex? Like,
that's...
I'm not going to answer that.
Yeah, see, we'll leave her alone. Oh, that's why I didn't want to say anything.
Yeah.
I'm not going to answer.
That's all?
That's all.
Whenever she says she's not answering, she's not answering. You just bring up the questions. That's
yeah,
fine.
You can ask. We like Renee.
No problem
very
with that.
Open on this show.
Yeah.
I think I know.
What?
Oh. I'm
trying to think.
Are you a...
Where's Scott Muni when you need him?
Well, it's not bad.
That's for someone that lingers very long.
I know what you're thinking. I'm not going to answer that either.
No.
I'm not going to answer that.
Knows.
I'm not going either way.
It's all good.
Were you raised by religious people?
No.
Oh, okay.
Oh, absolutely not. No. Roman Catholic. But not well. Not strictly. Not strictly, strictly. No. We're good.
We're good.
Look, there's just a lot of healthy people in this studio today.
It's all what about good, girls?
No matter what.
Do you have any kind of physical attraction to girls?
No.
You?
No, not at all.
All right. Just asking.
No.
No.
Oh, you? No.
We're all the Jimmy.
Yeah, yeah, no, I like girls. They're swell.
All right.
Especially ones with no gag reflex.
That could just mean you have a real small dick.
I'll go to you for that one.
Oh.
Oh, look at Pat. He was very confident
look at
about
Pat.
That.
No, my dick is giant. It's huge.
Comment
as big
about
as my
Pat's,
head.
Comment about Pat's dick.
Nice size.
Nice size?
It's a nice size.
Nice yeah. dick.
I got a banana here.
The 2-3 inches.
Show us on the banana with the Sharpie. Here you go.
Yeah. Just draw on the Sharpie. On the Sharpie. On the banana with the Sharpie.
How
where
high Pat's, you know.
His dick ends. And we're talking not to the sack. We're talking to the pubic bone.
Well, I'm not going to
well, just, you know, like, yeah, okay. Like that?
Mm.
All right. Yeah.
Wait a minute.
You got to, now you keep you're giving him a little more.
Yeah, I think she's fucking cheating, Pat, an inch.
Yeah.
Take it out.
Oh, take it out. Take it out and get a hard on now.
Word now.
Come here. No.
I think it's cocky.
All right.
Not bad.
Yeah, nice cock.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah, we didn't make you uncomfortable, did
no,
we?
No, not at all.
We
not
like
at
you,
all.
Well, yeah, there's a lot of problems now. We didn't make you uncomfortable. Pat, you're not going to kill anyone in the studio, right?
Not today.
We're all good?
Yeah.
Great.
And you're okay?
I'm fine.
Why are we asking if everyone's okay?
Because we're all so scared.
Yeah. No, but we're not, we're just, it's a very normal chat about.
Of course it is.
Who cares?
Goober from Whackbag is applauding the 6-year linger longer. That just occurred.
Linger longer.
All right. Thank you. Thank you.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you to everybody.
Thank you. Ladies, gentlemen.
This is our cue to leave.
That's the get to
really
take
good.
Take
and
your
I'll clean this up.
Take your blow-up doll with you.
I like the asshole in the blow-up doll. It's just a fucking it's like a piggyback. A piggy bank's back. It's like a piggyback.
A piggyback.
Yeah, way to just shorten something and not make it a joke.
Renee gave us great radio today.
She's real. Mm-hmm.
It was nice.
We did.
Well, we
seriously, you did.
We didn't know anything about her, so it's interesting to get to know somebody you're working with.
A little bit, sure.
Yeah,
get to know people.
I had no
too.
Doubt in my mind.
Me neither. Mm-hmm.
No doubt. Hey, we got to do line
black?
Of the day. First of all, Greg Giraldo did a fine job. Gotham Comedy Club, tonight through Sunday, 212-367-9000.
Thanks for having me, fellas.
Did you have fun?
I had great, you know, part of the problem was I was more of an observer when you're listening to these things.
Yeah, you just kind of, you throw in, you lob them
I
in.
Enjoy it. You
dude,
know?
You fired out
it's
some
fun.
Great lines. Who are you kidding?
I wanna, you know, when you're talking about a girl with no gag reflex, it's hard for me to want to go, ha, here's my zinger.
And when you caught me with my hand in my lap, I wasn't doing anything, I was just, I kind of, my
I think you went for a squeeze, didn't you? You're ready to squeeze.
I fucking give about 6 squeezes, and then you notice, I'm like, I'm just resting.
I just know Jimmy too well. When she was talking about no gag reflex, I'm like,
I didn't
oh,
mean
boy.
It to be disrespectful. It's like you don't think.
No, it's just natural. Right. You can't help yourself.
Oh, you got it?
Yeah.
E-Rock.
Virgin.
Line of the day is brought to you by BodogFantasy.net. Play against our own Travis in a weekly pick'em league and win $4,000. It's free. All you have to do is open an account on BodogFantasy.net and pick the weekly winners. Here's a runner-up line of the day.
So it's like a C, a B.
Oh, you want a letter grade?
I just want a grade.
I'd give a B to the C.
Let's see. Here's another runner-up line of the day.
You look like you're wearing more of a Little House on the Prairie kind of top.
Yeah.
This shirt.
You should like be hanging with Laura Ingalls.
Yeah. Oh,
Ingalls.
Can you get me a bolt of gingham next time you swing by?
A bolt
and a bag of rock gingham.
Did I say Ingalls wrong or something?
No.
Laura Ingalls.
Angle.
But I didn't notice either until you just
it's
asked.
Ingalls.
Oh,
yeah.
Whatever, then I'm
so I have
that
it right.
Doesn't matter.
Did I have it right?
Laura Ingalls.
Yeah. What did I say?
With an I.
Daughter of the guy with the nice smile and rotted asshole. that's actually his fucking confirmation name.
Here's another runner-up line of the day.
for the top of his head.
No one makes
It makes it harder to get your balls into the top of his head because his hands are moving back and forth over the top.
Only a few people will get this, but screw it. He moves his heads over his hands over his head. Like Earl does when Earl's trying to think.
Oh, when Earl's thinking.
See?
A Mr. Bucket?
Not really. What
was that? Where was the joke? Oh, the Earl thing?
Yeah, but I stammered through the whole thing.
Oh, it was kind of a...
Mr. Bucket!
That's right. A Mr. Bucket. A Mr. Bucket. Toss your balls in my top. A Mr. Bucket. Out of my mouth and will pop. A Mr. Bucket. We're all gonna run. A Mr. Bucket.
The game's Mr. Bucket. The first to get their balls into Mr. Bucket wins, but look out, because the balls will pop out of his mouth.
I'm Mr. Bucket. The balls pop out of my mouth. I'm Mr. Bucket. A ball is what I'm about. I'm Mr. Bucket. We're all going to run. I'm Mr. Bucket.
Mr. Bucket from Milk and Bradley.
All right. Now that we're not on terrestrial radio,
yes. Yeah.
What I want to do with Mr. Bucket is I want to put my cock right in his fucking bucket nose mouth and drop warm liver into him so it fucking shoots like warm liver all over my fucking my dick.
All over your cock.
His Mr. Bucket throat.
As your balls come out of his mouth.
And as I'm fucking Mr. Bucket, if the parents walk in, I'll give him that fucking Mr. Roper smile.
Where he used to just turn around and make that dopey smile.
Yeah,
the they'd like stay on him for a while.
Where are we at?
One more
runner-up. All right.
Oh, shit. Get out all of your cock.
Mr. Bucket.
Another runner-up line of the day.
You know, he would do like self-depreciating black guy jokes, and you know how people love that.
Oh, yeah.
And
yeah,
later he would rape them.
That was hilarious. And when Ron said that they went to see fucking Brian Regan, they just brought a covered dish.
Covered dish.
Why did we even bother doing the first 3 hours of radio? Mm. Nothing funny from the first three, huh?
Lots of stuff.
Here's your line of the day.
Here comes Line of the day.
Ankle bracelet, you're saying, E-Rock? That would never be an option for you if you committed a crime. You know that, right?
Have to cut it off with a hacksaw. You can't get to the latch.
My God, we just put this thing on. We got to get a larger one.
His leg would grow over it like when a tree eats a sign on the side of the road.
Whoosh.
Us indeed.
Wow. They
following the E-Rock formula for the line of the day.
Yes.
Make fun of the E-Rock, you get line of the day.
You instantly get line of the day.
Stone Cold Steve Austin on the show tomorrow?
I think so, yeah.
All right.
And also Otto and George and Voss.
And Voss.
Stone Cold Steve Austin. There's probably a couple of people very excited about tomorrow's show. I would think E-Rock, very excited. I would think Sam, very excited. Is he bringing in the belt?
Is Stone Cold a hero of yours?
No.
Someone you look up to? Someone you admired?
Did you know his hero list? He ain't on it.
Fucking
it's
dude.
Dad and Opie.
Hulk Hogan.
And Hulk Hogan.
Honestly, answer correctly. Did you ever get choked up listening to that song Hulkster in Heaven?
No.
You know the song?
Yeah, I sent it to them.
You what?
When they played it, I sent it to them.
Why?
Because I had it.
You thought it was nice?
What do you like about Hulk Hogan? That he's one of your heroes.
I used to like him when he was wrestling.
Explain why.
Yeah.
I don't know. Why does anybody like him? He was exciting to watch.
Excited. So he made you excited?
Why did he make you excited?
Tell us.
I just did.
What was
you
your
know?
Fantasy with Hulk? That he would be your friend or pick you up and take you to the mall? What did you want with Hulk?
No. Don't you even come in.
You
here.
Wanted to be a little Hulkster?
Are you a Hulkamaniac?
I was.
Are you?
I was a kid.
Did you wear the Hulk outfit?
No, because my
the Hunk.
My dad hated wrestling and refused to buy me anything.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know what that was about, right? He thought you were gay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Little fruity son with a bunch of
wrestling
shirtless man posters. Fucking laying there with a tent in your little fat boy pants, watching Hulk Hogan with his blonde mullet.
Did you go to the wrestling shows and like see Hulk rip his shirt off?
No.
And then
what did the
it
Hulk
would happen with you, but just after lunch?
What did the Hulk preach?
Yeah.
To train, say your prayers, and eat your vitamins.
Yeah.
Why didn't you listen?
Hey, the fat thing is only recent. I never was like
it's only recent. That's a sound.
I love how he defends himself by saying the fat thing is only recent.
Relatively speaking, recent. Like, you know, Vietnam.
How is Hulk a hero? What did he do to him a hero? That's a big statement.
Yeah.
You put that as an adult. You didn't put that as a child. It was fucking, it was your dad, it was Opie, and it was fucking Hulk Hogan.
Did you wish he would give you the leg drop?
Yeah. No.
A leg drop.
Oh, growing up in the 80s, you watched wrestling. You liked Hulk Hogan.
Did you?
I grew up in the 80s. I watched wrestling.
Yeah, but you're a little older than me.
I preferred Bob Backlund.
Oh, he just bashed you, Jimmy.
I liked Ivan
Putski.
The Polish Hammer.
Yes.
And?
Who do you like? Chief J?
No, I was pretty much a fan of... I have no fucking
Bruno?
Idea.
Bruno?
I really didn't
Bruno
care
San
about
Martino?
Wrestling in the 80s. I didn't care about wrestling until we were on the radio, and it was worth our while to give a shit about wrestling.
Yeah, we had to make believe. I remember that, too.
But then I kind of got into it like a soap opera, you know? You kind of watch a few episodes and go, hey, what's going on there?
I was a big fan of Andre the Giant.
Yeah, he was the one.
There you go.
Andre.
Do you know I named my cock after a midget wrestler? I swear to God, Coconut Willie.
You call your cock Coconut Willie?
As a kid, I did, yeah. I just named my penis Coconut Willie because I saw a little man named Coconut Willie, and I just thought that should be what your genitals are called.
It's pretty good. It's not bad.
Yeah.
Sam, excited about Stone Cold coming in?
Extremely
Jesus.
Excited, yeah.
D-Rock threw the mic at him.
I mean, he's not my hero or anything, but yeah, I'm pretty pumped.
Now, are you bringing in the belt?
No.
Why?
Because I figured once I got the belt out of here in one piece...
You were lucky?
...that I would not press my luck again.
You know what I would do with the belt?
What's that?
I would have every wrestler sign the back of it.
See, I was thinking about that, but technically, Stone Cold didn't hold that belt.
It doesn't matter. It's like, I think if you kept going for years and got wrestlers to sign that belt, it would be worth...
A lot of
so
money.
Much money
yeah.
After they like die. Think 20 years from now, if you have wrestlers that are wrestling now.
I have a steel chair for like 2.5 years. Oh, I've been getting wrestlers to sign.
Well, do you lug a chair around, huh? Oh, is that someone signing your chair?
Stone Cold.
Oh, it is Stone Cold. Yes, yes, it is.
I'd like to put get really wet clothes and then just sit on that chair.
Just Windex it once. It's
Bill,
gone.
Bill from Waterford. E-Rock probably used to try to rip his own shirt off, but he was too lazy and fat body to do so.
Oh. He'd like go, and he'd tear it and then fatly fall through a glass table.
When would you give up? When would you give up on trying to rip your own shirt off? Yeah, George the Animal Steel, sure. He didn't turnbuckle.
Mm-hmm.
They should have kicked him out of the league for that.
Yeah. No reason for that.
Why don't we do a little Iron Sheik, because that's Ant's favorite. Iron Sheik as we say goodbye today.
Iron
Sheik.
Greg
Giraldo, a pleasure, man.
Thanks, fellas.
Yes.
Thanks for having me.
Everyone
thanks
a lot,
for popping
a lot
in, sure.
I learned a lot about eating pussy.
Eating some pussy,
stuff.
Yeah.
Remember that, pussy good.
Yeah.
And there's
asshole
the
smells like mushroom.
I gotta find that doctor that does the shocker.
Yeah, I got. They'll help you out, right?
I got a doctor for you. I went in for strep throat, and he stuck a finger up my ass.
Nice.
Yeah, not once but twice.
Did it work?
Checking the hard way. Wow. And of course, the lovely girls of Pal Talk. When is Miss Pal Talk?
Tomorrow, $500.
Tomorrow, $500 up for grabs.
Yep.
Miss Pal Talk,
I
see a winner up on the screen right now. The cute, sweet Jody.
Where's Jody?
Isn't she adorable?
Where's Jody?
Look, she's not shaking her head. No, she gets so embarrassed.
Why is Jody embarrassed?
She's got such lovely red hair. I can't.
Aunt prefers a younger looking gal. Which
I think she's very cute.
She was at FH.
I don't like old ragged whores.
I'm not saying,
she was at FH.
Yeah, I met her at FH.
Colonel from Boogie Nights, I'm not saying you do.
Colonel!
I don't do anything with them.
They're just so cute. Oh, that's hysterical. Colonel from Boogie Nights.
Do you just pick him up and hold him? Just say you're my friend, Opie. Opie, say you're my friend.
Wow. Oh, is that bad?
Who's going to win Miss Pal Talk? Who's the favorite? A lot of people saying baby girl. Who's going to win tomorrow?
Yeah, a lot of people saying Marissa. But now that the angle's been thrown in where it's also kind of a talent competition.
Red rum. You got to think red rum.
You got to. I don't know. It's all up for grabs at this point. Do we just go with sheer looks or do we go with talent competition?
Yeah. We'll find out tomorrow. There's your big tease for
Jody's
today.
He's like, I'm not doing shit. Don't worry.
Yeah, just like blow dry your hair and put some makeup on tomorrow. You'll be fine.
Can I? You already did something. You pulled your hair back in that ponytail. She had to get up and bend over and pull it into a ponytail.
I think pigtails will win tomorrow.
Pigtails might garner a favor with me.
Pigtails with a baseball bat up your ass, I think.
No, baseball.
What?
A lisp and an altered birth certificate.
Yeah, that'll get you right to the top tomorrow.
Or be funny. Like, have like a half a log sticking out of your ass and just spin in a circle.
Wait, what's the half a log that goes back in called again?
Oh, wait.
Dipsy doodle?
The old dipsy doodle.
The old dipsy doodle.
Like when a girl's on her stomach and she kind of starts to shit and the log pokes it like a soldier of a tank. That's the old dipsy doodle.
The old dipsy doodle.
Or the old looky loo. Looky loo.
It takes a little look around.
Yeah, the old peekaboo.
Soldier coming out of a foxhole for a second.
Yeah, just taking a peek around.
He swims out of the cave, goes back into the cave. Shit me a sheepshank.
The dipsy doodle.
Dipsy doodle.
The old dipsy doodle. But the difference, Greg has to know.
Yeah.
The difference is like when you're on your stomach, the shit pokes out. That's like the old peekaboo.
That's just a little one, yeah.
The dipsy doodle is when she's squatting and she lets the piece come out and like she sucks it back up and it kind of curls and swipes the side of her leg.
Yeah, swings a little, yeah.
It gets a little wild, like a monkey
that's
tail.
Disgusting.
I'm trying to think of which one is hotter.
I don't know. It depends on what I'm in. I get a tomato.
Everyone's got their own take on it.
Wow.
Wow, that is just brutal.
And someone's got to tell Oscar De La Hoya he can't be in the Miss Pal Talk contest tomorrow.
How fucking embarrassing for Oscar, man. Ugh. God damn.
Yeah, that's, you don't want to be wearing a fishnet outfit.
Not when
and
you're
ladies' panties.
When your job is to fucking hit people. Like, he's a tough
beat
guy.
Beat the shit out of people. Yeah.
He should just wear that in the ring the next time.
Hey. Painted nails.
Fluster the opposition.
What gets cut from the replay now that we went late?
I don't know. I got to ask Danny.
Well, let's not do it all willy-nilly. Let's fucking...
I say the interview we did.
Okay.
It's an easy choice today. Easy choice today, if you know what I mean.
Okay.
Let's do that. Right. Greg Giraldo, Gotham, tonight through Sunday. We're out.
Thanks, fancy guys.
Later.
This is Aaron Sheik, World Wrestling Federation, three-time champion, All-American AAU champion. Pleasure for me to the Anthony and Opium bring me here to New York to I say hello to all my wrestling fans and everybody know I'm the real Middle Eastern man come to the greatest wrestling country and most famous city in the world, Manhattan, Madison Square Garden. Come three times champion. I want to say hello to all my wrestling fans, especially all American and also my Iranian friend. خدمت همه شنوندگان ایرانی عزیز سلام عرض میکنم. همه دنیا آرون شیخ خسرو وزیری رو میشناسن. Pleasure for me to I come back here again one more time to I talk to the Opium and Anthony and pleasure for me always.